Good start.
All right. See what happens tonight. We'll be with you after the ballgame for extra innings. Pedro Martinez in studio, but now stand by for Boston Red Sox baseball. The Yankees, those second-place Yankees, and your first-place Red Sox next.
Hey, surfing?
Investing. Transferring money from my Fleet checking account into my Quick and Riley account.
Wait, you can do that? You don't have to have like a Section 3 or a Series 85 or something?
Nope.
Like
those? Nope. Everything's right here.
Yeah, mutual funds, bonds.
Even a personal financial consultant you can call.
Yeah, your total financial picture all in one place.
With just a click.
My financial picture's a little out of focus.
Hey, can I roll over my 401k money into an IRA account at Quick and Riley, you know, from an old job?
Sure.
You got an IRA?
Yes, I think so. They just, basically at this new job, they just got me a big pack of papers, and I just gave that to my wife. She told me to come in here and ask you guys how to figure it all out. You guys good at spotting value funds that translate into long-term earnings growth? What do you guys think about the small cap T-bills? Can't catch your tongue? Yeah, don't know so much about that, do you?
Closed captioning for Red Sox baseball on NESN is provided by Verizon, the Yawkey Foundation, Dunkin' Donuts, and Aflac.
Live from Fenway Park in Boston, NESN presents exclusive coverage of Boston Red Sox baseball. Tonight, the Red Sox take on the New York Yankees. Hi, everybody. I'm Don Orsillo, and welcome to Red Sox baseball. Game two of the series against the Yankees as the Red Sox and Yankees renew their rivalry. And tonight, the Red Sox will go up against the Rocket, Roger Clemens. Of course, the active leader with 287 wins, tied with Burt Blylevin in that category. 3,789 strikeouts, third most all-time, trailing only Nolan Ryan and Steve Carlton. And of course, the six-time Cy Young Award winner, the Major League record. As always, we welcome in Jerry Remy. And Jerry, an exciting time at the ballpark tonight, and Roger on the mound.
Well, it's always fun to come to the ballpark when you see great pitching. And of course, last night you had Pedro Martinez working for the Red Sox. A lot of excitement around here. Tonight you have Roger Clemens. Now, as soon as Roger sticks his head out of the dugout, they're going to boo him all the way to the bullpen. They'll boo him all the way back in, and probably every time he takes the mound, but he loves that. He's had great success against the Red Sox. When you look at the lineup tonight, the only guy that's really done any damage against him is Trot Nixon. He's got over a 400 batting average with a couple of home runs. Go get him, Trot.
Hey, it may only be May, but this place is jacked. Red Sox and Yankees back after this. Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Fenway Park tonight. A very nice night so far here with blue skies above, some clouds moving in, and game two, this series against the New York Yankees, and Fenway jam-packed, as you might imagine. A terrific crowd on hand. Let's take a look at the visiting Yankees starting lineup. Alfonso Soriano at the top of the lineup at second base. 67 hits to lead the American League. Derek Jeter bats second at shortstop. Bernie Williams in center field. Jason Giambi, the first baseman. Jorge Posada does the catching with Robin Ventura, third baseman. John Vandewall in right field. Rondell White in left. And Nick Johnson is the DH. He bats ninth.
And the defense tonight for the Red Sox, Hillenbrand at third, Garcia Parra at shortstop, Sanchez at second, Jose Offerman at first. Left to right, Daubach, Damon, and Nixon. Veritek behind the plate. And on the mound, right-handed John Burkett. Start number seven, a perfect 5-0 for Burkett, the 2.57 ERA. He has never had a win against a Yankee team. In seven career starts, a record of 0-5 with a 10.95 ERA.
And certainly he would like to take care of the past, the 0-5 and the high earned run average, as Soriano out after the first pitch grounds it into the Boston dugout. -83 degrees to begin the ball game tonight at Fenway. The lights are on. Soriano at .316 on the year with 11 homers and 33 runs batted in. And he takes the strike quickly in the hole, nothing in two. John Burkett may be 0-5 against the Yankees, but he comes in at 5-0 this season for the Red Sox. This is fouled off the foot of Soriano. And he will hobble around a little bit. Was Burkett winning his last start against Seattle at Fenway back on May the 19th and went five innings. Look back over the outings that Burkett has had this season. He's been around the 5 to 6 inning area. He has gone to seven innings only once. That was at Tampa Bay on May 3rd. And as part of his victory last time, went five and then turned it over to the bullpen. Was fighting the cold a couple of starts ago and of course began the year in the DL with the shoulder problem. As they work on Soriano, and now Joe Torre will join the trainer for the Yankees.
Yeah, it looks like it got him right inside that left knee. He's got the guard on the ankle, but this one will get him on the knee. Burkett goes inside with the fastball, hits on top of it, and right off the knee. Now, I don't see any of that freeze yet. No, no freeze. Just a little pat on the back and let's go get him. But it's not going to get any better than this.
The fraudulent freeze. Alfonso Soriano will be followed by Derek Jeter and Bernie Williams. They're in the top of the first inning. Burkett ready with the 0-2. Off speed, drops it maybe a little high. Maybe a little inside. 1-2. Chris Burkett works with mainly soft stuff. Much different from what the Yankees faced last night in Pedro Martinez in the first game of the series. Soriano waves at it, gets away from Veritek. He'll have to throw him out, and does. Out number one. A strikeout for John Burkett.
Let's take a look at tonight's game notes brought to you by Sullivan Tire and Auto Service. The Yankees, a .217 average, 5 home runs and 18 runs in the 5 games this year at Fenway. Roger Clemens' career at Fenway Park, 98-55, 3.16 ERA. And the Red Sox, .293 team average and a .321 team ERA. Both of those are first in the American League.
One out, nobody on. Derek Jeter, the bat for the first time tonight. .312, 6 homers and 26 runs driven in. The lip of the grass at third is Shea Hillenbrand. There's the first one in there for a strike to Jeter. So Jeter 2-for-4 in the first game of the series last night as a season-high hitting streak of 14 games. The most for a Yankee hitter this year. As he darts out of the way of that pitch, 1-1. Jeter in the 2 spot tonight. In there for a strike over the inside corner, 1-2.
We gave you those numbers, Burkett, against the Yankees, but he hasn't faced him since 99. He's a different pitcher than the last time the Yankees saw him when he was with Texas. Soriano still getting some work done on that knee.
Now the 1-2 to Jeter. Swung on and missed. He struck him out. Back-to-back K's to open up the outing for John Burkett. 2 down.
Well, that's been a surprising thing about John Burkett, the number of strikeouts. He now has 29 strikeouts in 35 2/3 innings. Fastball outside corner by Jeter. Jeter, a very tough player to strike out.
Two down, and it brings up the switch hitter, Bernie Williams, as Jeter back to the dugout, the owner of the second strikeout of the night for John Burkett. Bernie Williams at 282, 9 homers and 24 runs batted in. Williams was 0 for 3 last night. Sends one towards the gap in left center. This is going to grab some wall. Kicks off. Damon plays it quickly and guns it in. Head first into second base with a two-out double goes Bernie Williams. The first hit of the night for the Yankees.
Well, one thing that hasn't changed for Bernie Williams, he just wears out John Burkett. A 571 average coming into the game tonight, and he doesn't waste any time. He picks on that first fastball away and hits it hard off that left field wall. The wind right now has changed. The wind is blowing from left to right. When we came to the ballpark today, it was blowing straight out towards center field. And it's blowing pretty good right now.
Yeah, that's a pretty good gust. And the flag in left center indicates the same. Here's Jason Giambi, the cleanup hitter for the Yankees. 306, 10 homers and 31 runs driven in for Giambi. Jason was 1 for 4 with a double last night. 7 hits in his last 18 at bats. There are no Giambis left in Oakland, as his brother Jeremy traded away to Philadelphia recently. So all the Giambis have vacated Northern California. Popped up back to second. Nomar's got it lined up. Now gives way to Sanchez. He'll make the catch to retire the side. Yankees lead Bernie Williams in scoring position. Half an inning done. No score. Red Sox coming up. Nesson's exclusive coverage of Boston Red Sox baseball is brought to you in part by Southwest Airlines, bringing people together with low fares. By Miller Lite, life is best told at a place called Miller Time. And by your friends at Mobil, who remind you to use SpeedPass, today's way to pay. Back at Fenway Park, the Yankees unable to score in the first. Red Sox coming to the plate in the bottom of the first. A lineup that has Johnny Damon at the top of the order in center field. Jose Offerman inserted at first base. Omar Garcia-Parra batting third. Ryan Daubach in left. Hillenbrand at third base. Trotnickson very good against Clemens, 8 for 19. Jason Veritek does the catching. Carlos Baerga's the DH batting eighth. Ray Sanchez at second base bats ninth.
Defense for the Yankees, Ventura, Jeter, Soriano, Giambi in the infield, White, Williams, Van de Waal in the outfield, Posada behind the plate, and on the mound, Roger Clemens.
13th time that he has faced the Red Sox. Johnny Damon takes ball one from Roger. There are the numbers.
The 7th win coming last time out against Minnesota, the 287th of his career. Went by Robin Roberts on the all-time list. And tied Burt Blyleven for 22nd place. Once he gets by Blyleven, Tommy John will be next.
The win last time, his 6th straight win. Combined with Mariano Rivera last time on a 3-0 shutout. Lemon takes the pitch high. Clemens down 3-0 to the first hitter he faces tonight. Damon at 335, 3 homers and 18 runs driven in. Johnny was 1 for 3 with a double here last night. On 4 pitches, Damon works the walk.
Really, the only negative in Clemens' numbers, that's the 27th walk of the season for Roger in 67 and 2/3. 72 strikeouts puts him second right now behind Pedro, who has 73 to lead the league.
Was a member of the Red Sox from 84 through 1996, Roger Clemens. Again, his 13th appearance against his old ball club tonight. He now deals with Jose Offerman. An auspicious beginning. 5 straight balls for Clemens. Offerman at 269, 3 homers and 15 runs driven in. And a Roger chant for the first time tonight. In there for a strike, 1-1.
Well, if Clemens gets a little bit more pumped up for these games against the Red Sox, you can understand why his control would be off in the first inning. Here's his career numbers against his former club, a 2.10 ERA and 12 starts.
Damon takes off. Offerman will take a strike, and Johnny is effective second. Got a great jump. Steals second base and jumps up into scoring position with nobody out.
14 now for Damon on the season behind Lofton and Ichiro. And that jump was certainly on Roger Clemens. Damon going in head first, just like Ricky Henderson.
Offerman waiting on the 1-2, swinging and missing. And a strikeout for Clemens, the first out in the bottom of the first inning.
Looks like the split of that time for Clemens to pick up the strikeout.
Well, the Yankees are 1-4 at Fenway Park this season after the 3-1 loss last night. Of course, Red Sox took 3 out of 4 the first time they were in. Nomar stands in at 304 on the season. And gets out of the way of that offering.
Nomar has had his troubles in his career against Clement, a 107 batting average.
Nomar goes the opposite way and drops it into right field for a base hit. Damon's coming around. He will score. Red Sox on top, 1-0.
Little flare to the opposite field. That ball down and in. Garcia Parra able to get the good part of the bat on it. Drops in front of Van de Waal, and the Red Sox have the 1-0 lead. Nomar picks up RBI number 35 to tie him with Ramirez and Hillenbrand for the team lead.
Now Daubach stands in the cleanup spot tonight. Brian, the left fielder. And a quick check on Nomar, back in plenty of time. Daubach at 323, 6 homers and 20 runs batted in. And last night off was at a very good homestand, hitting at 370 on the current homestand. 10 for 27 on this homestand. The longest homestand of the year for the Red Sox, a 13-gamer, which we'll wrap up on Sunday at the conclusion of this 4-game series with New York. In there for the strike to Daubach. Roger Clemens, 39 years of age, his 11th start of the year. Throw over. Nomar back in plenty of time.
More attention paid here to Nomar than Johnny Damon. Plus the walk, stolen base, turned into a quick run for the Red Sox.
One out, last of the first. The Red Sox have already plated a run as Daubach fights that pitch off. Foul back to the backstop. Nothing in two. Last Sunday, picking up his 287th win of his career. He surpassed Robin Roberts on the all-time list, tied Burt Blylevin for 22nd place all-time. He's a win tonight to surpass Blylevin and to tie Tommy John, who's next. That's a way to Daubach, 1-2. And you see the all-time win leaders. Tommy John is next. And he tied with Blylevin. Roger on the DL in 2000 in July, and since then coming off the DL, 36-7, 61 regular season starts. Most concerned with the progress of Nomar Garcia Parra at first. Two to Daubach. That foul down the first baseline. Still 1-2. Martinez coming off a season in which he recorded 213 strikeouts last year. Seventh highest single season total in Yankee history. Most 248 by Ron Guidry back in 1978. And back again in plenty of time. First one out. Daubach patiently awaiting the pitch. Finally it comes away and it's 2-2. Clemens, the active leader in career wins. Game started, innings pitched, strikeouts in complete games. Here's his pitching coach, Mel Stottlemyre. The 2-2. Rep foul off the left side, still 2-2. Joe Torre in his seventh season at the helm of the Yankees. Fresh off a season in which he won 95 games. The first Yankees manager to guide them to six straight postseason appearances as Daubach lashes a foul off the left side.
Now the Red Sox making Clemens work hard here in the first inning. The walk, stolen base, a strikeout, throwing a lot of pitches, the base hit. And now a long at bat hit by Brian Daubach.
This will be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. Johnny Damon has scored here in the bottom of the first inning. This will be pitch number 17 of the inning. In the air, foul off the left side. Robin Ventura gives it a look, as does Rondell White, but well back and out of play.
So far, the fastballs from Clemens have ranged anywhere from 89 to 94 miles an hour.
Well, it's been a Yankee starting rotation that has been banged up. They've been without Andy Pettitte and an injury to El Duque, and David Wells missed his last start, scheduled to appear in this series. The 2-2. Daubach grounds it through the vacated right side out of the reach of Soriano. Nomar's headed for third. The throw is cut off. Daubach with a base hit. Boston with runners at the corners and one down.
Battle put on there by Brian Daubach. Fouled off a number of pitches. Finally got a fastball down that he's able to hook just to pass the dive of Soriano. Garcia Parra hustling all the way. The throw is going to be cut off by Jeter to keep that double play in order.
A long battle for Brian Daubach. He's the winner this time. Jay Hillenbrand will be next with runners at the corners and one down. One for four last night. He is hit at 308 on this lengthy homestand, 12 for 39. In the air to left, down the line towards the pole, bending towards the pole, and it will be a foul ball. Not much room for foul ground, but somehow Hillenbrand found it.
Well, we mentioned the wind blowing all of a sudden from left to right, and that kept this baseball with a chance to be fair. And you can see there clearly just to the left of that yellow line going up the left field wall. That ball started out like it was going to be fouled by Alani, got a push by the wind, and just in foul territory.
The next home run for Shea Hillenbrand will jump up into double figures for Shea. He's got nine on the season. The opposite field this time, foul off the right side as he punches at it. 0-2 to Hillenbrand. Yankees are number one in home runs. They're first. Red Sox are fifth in the American League. Clemens trying to get out of this first inning. The 0-2. Chopped at right side and into right field for a base hit. From third comes Nomar. Heading for third is Daubach. He'll get there. The Red Sox lead it 2-0.
Well, sometimes you also have to be a little bit lucky when you face some great pitches, and I would say Hillebrand a little lucky here. Watch the location of this fastball up and away, and just chops it one big high hop over the head of Giambi for the base hit. So Hillebrand retakes the lead, team lead in RBIs with 36. That ball was almost eye high and outside.
And the Roger chants go up again from the Fenway faithful here in the bottom of the first inning. He's been touched for a pair. Red Sox trying to get some more. Certainly know that when you have the opportunity to get to a pitcher like Roger, you need to take advantage of that opportunity. Nixon has been a guy who's done very, very well against Roger Clemens, and been talking to Trout before the game. Says he certainly gets up for every time that he faces Roger Clemens, anytime he faces a future Hall of Famer, but take a look at those numbers. And I think the highlight of all of those numbers, the two-run home run of Yankee Stadium in that marvelously pitched game. It may be the highlight of Trout Nixon's career in regards of things he will think back on when his career is all over. Checked his swing, offered, according to home plate umpire Paul Schreiber. And it's 1-2 now to Nixon.
Clemens that time going to the split-fingered fastball, and the swing call by the home plate umpire did not ask down to third base for an appeal.
Clemens with 25 pitches already. Ready with the 1-2. Off the outside edge, 2-2. Eleventh appearance of the year for Clemens. David Wells scheduled to go in this series. His back has been ailing him a little bit. The 2-2 to Nixon. Whoa, 3-2. Veritek waits on deck.
If they have Hillebrand running at first base on the 3-2 count. Usually 3-2, Grady Little lets him go.
Giambi holds him on as Clemens peers in. Ready with the payoff pitch. Grounded towards shortstop very slowly. Jeter on the run and in time, but a run will score. In from third comes Daubach with the third Boston run.
The only play for Derek Jeter was to go to first base to get the out. Could not go home, did not have time to do that. Could not go to second base to try to get a double play. Took the sure out at first base. The Red Sox have got runs on the last two hitters. One, a big high bounce up over the head of Giambi. The other, a little dribble at a shortstop, but you take them any way you can get them against Roger Clemens.
Here's Jason Veritek. That's from the left side against the right-hander. Up and away, ball one to Veritek. Jason at 269 on the year. Four homers and 19 runs batted in. 0 for 4 in game one of the series. And hitting a 222 on the homestand. Hillebrand at second. Two down. And up and away again, 2-0. That's the 30th pitch of this, the first inning from Roger Clemens. Ready with the 2-0 to Veritek. In there for the strike right down the pike. 2-1. The Red Sox with a two-game advantage as a result of their victory here last night in game one, 3-1. Both clubs with 31 wins, but the Red Sox with 13 losses under Grady Little. Evens up at 2-2. Big cut by Veritek.
Amazing thing about Clemens, of similar to Nolan Ryan, even at the advanced age, and Roger will be 40 pretty soon, still a power pitcher. And Nolan Ryan was a power pitcher right till the day he retired.
He's still probably a power pitcher wherever he is.
Advil.
That's right. The 2-2 is chopped right side. Soriano rounds in behind it. The soft toss, and that'll do it. But the Red Sox get to Clemens three times in the bottom of the first. We're done with 1-3-0 Boston.
Back at Fenway, the Red Sox jump out to the 3-0 lead. Let's take a look at the home run leaders around baseball, brought to you by New England Ford Dealers. Ventura, Rodriguez, Torrijano, Delgado tied with 12. Soriano and Chavez with 11. In the National League, Sammy Sosa with 17. Bonds now with 16. Rickman 15. Cliff Floyd and Vladimir Guerrero tied with 13.
President and now MVP, huh?
Tough to get the MVP when you can't even get on the field anymore.
And of course, the fine owner of the New England Patriots on hand here for the Red Sox-Yankee series. Mr. Kraft positioned just to the left of the Red Sox dugout. Down near John Henry's seats. On to the second inning. John Burkett now three runs in which to work with. Posada, Ventura, and Vanderwall expected in the visiting half of the second inning. That'll drop in for strike one. Posada at 301, seven homers and 31 runs driven in. Yankees catcher who had a double last night off Pedro Martinez. Posada was 1-for-4 with that double last night. Now two hits in his last 15 at bats. Really had a very good year offensively last year. In the last couple years, if you look at 2000 to 2001 in regards to RBIs, the only catcher that he's behind in the major leagues in terms of ribbies is Mike Piazza. 2-2 the count to Posada, two-time All-Star. While his offense terrific, he struggled defensively last year with 11 errors. A major league leading 18 passed balls. The 2-2. In there for strike three. Third strikeout for John Burkett.
I don't know what the ratio is, Don, this year, but it seems like Burkett probably has more strikeouts caught looking than swinging. He's able to mix his pitches up. That time picks up the outside corner. Took a little something off the fastball and gets Posada looking. They don't swing and miss that much, but they do get caught looking a lot.
Ventura now stands in at 250 on the year, the Yankees' third baseman. 12 home runs and 33 runs batted in. He's tied for first in home runs with Alex Rodriguez and Torrey Hunter. It's now 3-0 to Ventura. He's 0-for-2 with a walk last night and has just one hit in his last 12 at bats. And 3-1 to Ventura. Was acquired by the Yankees from the crosstown Mets for the offseason for David Justice. Now tipped into the catcher's mitt. Now it's gone full circle from 3-0 to a full count. Burkett with three strikeouts in his outing. Make it four over the outside corner, strike three. Back-to-back K's to open up the second inning for John Burkett.
Well, that's the exact same way he got Posada. Fastball, outside corner. And talk about painting the outside corner. Both those pitches in just about the exact same location. And Burkett fell behind 3-0. The most he's walked in the game this year is two. He's done that three times. The Red Sox as a staff have walked the fewest.
Line to right, Johnny Vanderwall with a base hit to right field. The second hit of the night for the Yankees. He didn't waste any time after watching the two previous hitters strike out. It's out after the first pitch and a base hit.
Vanderwall took an 0 for 3 last night against Pedro. Tonight jumps on the first pitch from Burkett and gets second hit of the night for the Yankees. Williams and now Vanderwall with hits.
Here's Rondell White, the left fielder, for the first time. You know, I know John Burkett said that he worked with Greg Maddux, got to watch him work, but he's been Maddux-like here tonight, especially against the Yankees. Rondell White, a disappointing 223 at this point of the year. 5 homers, 19 runs batted in. But after the 0-1, grounds it into center field for a base hit. Up 90 feet to second goes Vanderwall. The Yankees trying to get something going with two outs.
Now, to this point in the season, the Yankees have not got the offensive production they expected from Rondell White. Only 23 coming into the ball game. Does have 5 home runs, picks up that base hit. So two outs, the Yankees trying to do some damage against Burkett.
Veritek meeting with Burkett as they will prepare to deal with Nick Johnson. 1 for 2 with a run scored, the only run scored for the Yankees last night. A move for a pinch hitter in the 8th. It is major league debut for the Yankees a year ago at Texas. And maybe the most disappointed member of the Yankees during the offseason when Jason Giambi was picked up. It appeared Nick Johnson would be the guy at first base after Tino Martinez left. See him in regards to rookie RBI leaders behind Hinsky and Geronimo Heel. Fights it off the fist, foul, 1-1.
I guess that set you back a few days when they signed a guy to a contract like Giambi got, who's been an MVP in the league and second in the league a year ago.
And wants to play first base, did not want a DH. He made that very clear. And he has been pretty much the everyday first baseman. Johnson's been in there on some day games after night games. And giving Giambi some time off defensively, but Giambi's pretty much in there every day at first. 2-1 now to Nick Johnson.
Might have recognized that coach standing in front of Giambi. That's Rick Down, who last year was the hitting coach for the Red Sox. Back to the Yankee organization.
The second go-around, correct?
Yes. Tony Carniger also switching uniforms. He was in the bullpen a year ago for the Yankees.
Rich waved at by Nick Johnson. He was baffled on that offering. 2-2. This is wild on the scoreboard and left. 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Top of the second inning. 2 on for the Yankees. The 2-2 from Burkett. Got him. Strike 3. Strikes out the side. 5 Ks for John Burkett. Inning and a half done from Fenway. 3-0 Boston. Citizens exclusive coverage of Boston Red Sox baseball is brought to you in part by Citizens Bank, not your typical bank. By New England Ford. Ford is leading the way with the best-selling cars and trucks. Log on to NewEnglandFord.com for details. And by Rocky Mountain Cold Coors Light. Cold, down, easy. Bottom of the second inning. Carlos Baerga, Ray Sanchez, and Johnny Damon face Roger Clemens. Roger facing 7 members of the Red Sox in the first and had to throw 33 pitches in the first inning. And the Red Sox got to him for 3 runs. Carlos Baerga right even at the 300 mark with no homers and 2 runs batted in. It's now 2-1 to Carlos. Maierga placed into the lineup tonight, as was Jose Offerman. Ricky Henderson and Tony Clark getting the night off. In the second, Red Sox have had the lead man on in each of the first two innings.
Carlos Baeger leads one double in his career for 250. He jumps all over that fastball from Clemens, which was right down the heart of the plate to pick up the base hit.
Now Ray Sanchez, number nine hitter for the Red Sox. 316, a home run, 16 runs batted in. Well, the bulk of his fine offensive effort this season has come from the number nine spot. Sanchez was 2 for 3 with a double last night's action. Check on Baerga, back in plenty of time. Clemens facing the Red Sox for the 13th time in his career. One and one now to Ray Sanchez.
Mike Cubbage, the third base coach. I got an email the other day about what that is that Cubbage wears on his left hip. He is a diabetic. And that is an insulin pump that he wears. Has it with him all the time.
There goes Baerga. Sanchez out after the 1-1. Pops it up down the right field line. Foul. Doesn't quite reach Camiselli. I didn't know that.
I got an email question in a pregame show, and I did not know the answer to that. I knew it wasn't a cell phone that he was carrying during the game, so I checked with him in the clubhouse, and it's an insulin pump that he has to wear all the time.
I think Mike's done a very good job here this year.
He's done a very good job at third base. Because people will point to the Ramirez situation. But if Manny did not slide head first, it wouldn't have been an issue.
Grounded foul outside of third base. Well, this is certainly not an easy place to be a third base coach.
Just ask Rene Latchman when he was here. Say, Rene's the only guy that can mess up air traffic control over at Logan.
Wendell Kim didn't have a real good time of it either.
No, Wendell, no.
The 1-2, there goes Baerga again. Sanchez swinging again. Little fly ball to shallow center for Williams. One away, Baerga back to the bag at first.
Wendell would get real aggressive, and a guy get thrown out by 20 feet. And then his arms would get shortened up as the game went on. He didn't know whether to wave him or hold him.
The center fielder, Johnny Damon.
And this place could have that effect on you.
Top of the Red Sox order, Johnny Damon. Walked, stole second, and scored on the Nomar Garcia Parra base hit to right. Ventura stepping up to the lip of the grass for the Yankees at third. More aggressive throw over this time from Clemens. Baerga gets back. -83 degrees to begin action tonight at Fenway Park. Finally feels like summer in these parts. After what was a very chilly beginning to May. It has certainly warmed up for this wonderful weekend at Fenway between the Red Sox and the Yankees.
I look out at this high home camera here, and you look at the mound, you see the Red Sox, of course. Roger starting his career with the Red Sox here in the grass, and there he is in a Yankee uniform pitching against the Red Sox.
And the great debate as of late as to what hat Roger will wear when he goes into the Hall of Fame. It sounds as if the Hall of Fame may take that option away from some of the players that are inducted to take that element away. And it may be a situation that you end up with the most productive years of your career as a Hall of Famer. And that being the given decision on the hat, fouled off the left side, you could certainly argue that with that in mind, of course, a great career, 84 through 96 for Roger Clemens, that it would be a Red Sox at, perhaps. Well, the career wins leaders. Roger backs off and looks by Erga back to the bag.
How many years did Roger pitch here with the Red Sox?
84 through 96.
13 years. So when he goes in the Hall of Fame, he has every right to have his number retired out there in right field, right?
Absolutely. The 0-2. Up and away, and the count is 1-2.
That's true, too. Paul Calvert says you have to end your career with the Red Sox.
That's actually changed.
They brought back Fisk into the organization and put his number up there.
The new owners, I think, have stated that they're going to switch that. But that was an old policy of the Red Sox, and I think they have given up on that. As it is up and away, and the count is 2-2. That was something that was always here as a policy. But I think one of the things they said they're going to change was that.
Well, if that's the case, and you'll have Clemens up there, you'll have probably Wade Boggs up there.
It opens up a lot of possibilities for sure. I'd like to see the number two up there, Jerry Remy. The 2-2 is up and away.
They can't fool with the rules that much.
Well, they have room up there to wrap it around the pole. Still got lots of space. Now, you're good first. Lehman waiting. There goes Baerga. There's ball four. Doesn't matter. For the second time tonight, Johnny Damon has walked. He's the owner of the two walks given up by Roger Clemens tonight.
Roger's got good velocity so far in this game, but not good control. He's been all over the place. And then a lot of times he'll come with that fastball down the middle, and the Red Sox are getting some hits on it.
Offerman career against Clemens, 172, five walks. That was the 50th pitch for Roger Clemens. Roger had to throw 33 in the first inning. And expend a lot of energy as the Red Sox sent seven men to the plate, scored three times. The RBIs belonging to Garcia Parra, Hillenbrand, and Nixon in the first inning. Offerman, a one-hopper to Ventura. To second, what a throw sailed into right field. Baerga comes around and scores the fourth Boston run. Ventura sailed that one into right. The Red Sox have their fourth run of the night.
Well, for a guy that is a very steady and dependable third baseman, Ventura just lets this one fly, almost like it slipped out of his hand. The ball was hit hard, so Soriano was on his way to second base. He's not quite there yet, but you see the throw not even close to the mark. Ventura, a number of gold gloves at third base when he was in the American League with the White Sox.
He's got six of them in his career.
He's had some trouble here at Fenway Park, though. I remember one year with the White Sox, they opened the season, had an awful first series, and it kind of carried on throughout the year for him.
The six-time Gold Glove winner, 91 through 93, 96, 98, and again in 99. The conference at the mound, full-fledged conference, the entire infield in to join Mel Stottlemyre, great pitching coach of the Yankees. And Roger had a chance getting out of the inning. Could they have initiated or converted that double play? It was initiated. Robin Ventura tried to start the around the horn inning ending double play, but it ended up in right field, and the Red Sox have ended up with a 4-0 advantage. Now you get into the heart of the order. Nomar singled and drove in a run in the first. He bats with two in scoring position, but just a 138 career mark against Clemens. out after that first pitch. The infield in all the way around for the Yankees. Popped up. Back at first, the infield brought in, so Soriano's got to go a long way into right, makes the catch, trying to score from third is Damon. The throw is going to be not in time. Shallow fly to short right. Damon gives it a try and scores the fifth Boston run.
If I was Nomar Garciaparra, I'd go give him a big hug right now. He got me an RBI with a great hustle play. Because they're playing, and Soriano had a long way to go, and he's going to have to make that catch going away from home plate. And because of the speed of Johnny Damon, he can score. Soriano pivots, throws. It's going to be up the first base side. And Johnny Damon doesn't even have to slide. So how about that for a sack fly? That one's about, what, 100 feet from home plate.
Amazing. And a great burst of speed from Johnny Damon. Nomar picks up his 36th RBI of the year, second of the night. Runner at second, two down. Daubot swinging and missing. Upstairs that time, 0-1. See the great production by Daubot over the last 10 games. At least an average. 371.
Better believe he's happy about that.
Red Sox have gotten to Roger Clemens for 5 runs on 4 hits. Costly error in this inning as Daubot cranks it foul. Into the Boston dugout, 0-2. You don't think that Robin Ventura is not thinking about that right now.
It's like Joe's in disbelief.
A 3-1 loss last night, and they will work now with, at the very least, a 5-run deficit. And Clemens not yet out of the bottom of the second inning. Looking away, 1-2.
When you look at the hits for the Red Sox, the one that's been hardest hit is Baeges. There have been a couple of ground balls that have just squeaked their way through the infield. That big high bounce by Shea Hillenbrand. But it doesn't matter. There are 5 runs on the board.
Now the 1-2 to Daubot. Over the outside corner, strike 3. Second strikeout for Clemens, but the Red Sox get to him for 2 more. We play 2 from Fenway, 5-0 Red Sox. Don Orsillo and Jerry Remy back at Fenway as we're ready for the top of the third. 5-0, Red Sox on top. John Burkett has pitched 2 scoreless innings, ready to go in the third. At the top of the Yankees order, Alfonso Soriano. Here are the hits leaders. Soriano leading the American League. Eric Jeter right in behind him, third. There's another hit, hit number 68 for Soriano. And the Yankees, for the first time tonight, have the lead runner on.
Soriano leads a couple of different categories. You mentioned the hits, Don, 68 now. He also leads in doubles with 19. Talked about it last night. Not your usual leadoff hitter because he strikes out so much. He leads the league in that category with 56 strikeouts.
He struck out 125 times last year. And he struck out a lot, as Jerry mentioned this year. He struck out tonight in the first inning against John Burkett. 1 of 5 K's for the Boston right-hander. Here is Derek Jeter, also a strikeout victim in the first. Tech tried to bring that back on the back end. A 438 hitter against John Burkett, 7 for 16. Check on Soriano, back in plenty of time. Jeter participated in 150 games last year, but played much of the year hurt, dealing with a hamstring problem, problem with his throwing shoulder. Kind of battled his way through last year. Takes a good cut. And it's 1-1 now to Jeter. Soriano with a big lead over there at first. Had 43 stolen bases a year ago. This is on the ground. Garcia part of second for one. On to Offerman. They turn it. 6-4 to throw in the Twin game. 2-0.
That's the way Red Sox fans like it when Jeter hits the ground ball to Nomar so they can turn
number
over the
51.
Double play. Little underhand flip, straddles the bag, and just getting Jeter by a half a step at first base. Burkett, one who relies on his defense, has had some very good defense on this Red Sox club. The only team in the league playing better defense, numbers-wise, the Baltimore Orioles.
Two down, Bernie Williams batting for the second time. He doubled. Only extra base hit off Burkett so far. Look at his numbers against John. 9-for-15 his career against Burkett. There's Burkett with the Texas Rangers. And he was in the midst of his deliveries time call. Pedro Martinez in the studio tonight after the game for extra innings. Jim Corsi and Bob Rogers. 1-1 now to Williams. Williams, an all-star for the fifth time last year. That's the 1-1 chopped at Offerman. He'll take it alone, and that'll do it. The double play helps out John Burkett in the inning. We play 2.5 from the fence, 5-0 Red Sox. Back at Fenway Park on a beautiful evening. The Red Sox have enjoyed the night so far on top 5-0. As they come to the plate in the bottom of the third. Clemens 58 pitches deep into his outing. He's had to expend a lot of energy in his first two innings of work tonight. 3 runs for Boston in the first, 2 in the second. A check swing from Hillenbrand, able to hold up. Shea singled and drove in a run in the first inning. On the ground, onto the ground, and now caught by Jeter on the ground, but reaching it first with the infield hit is Hillenbrand. That was under the glove of Robin Ventura, ranging to his left, and then Jeter on the short lawn and left corralled it, but on at first with his second hit of the night is Shea Hillenbrand.
Yeah, I think even if Ventura is able to make this play, by the time he spins around to throw, Hillenbrand would have a pretty good chance of beating that at first base.
He'll be held on by Jason Giambi. It is the third consecutive inning in which the Red Sox have gotten the lead man on. Nixon bounced to short his first time. Damon walked in the first inning. Baerga single to open up the second, and now Hillenbrand with the infield hit to begin the bottom of the third inning.
Fifth infield hit of the year for Hillenbrand. Third on the team. Damon has 9. Sanchez has 6.
In the air to left center field. Struck pretty well. Bernie Williams is looking up. It's up off the wall. Williams will play to Kara. Hillenbrand is running. The throw from Jeter will not be in time. Nixon at third will be out. Trying to get the third with the throw going to the plate. But Hillenbrand is in with the 6th Boston run. 6-0 Red Sox.
Now Nixon continues to do damage against Roger Clemens. This shot going to the opposite field, off the wall, going with the fastball. Red Sox score Hillenbrand, but then Nixon gets trapped in a rundown. He'll get thrown out at third base. 2 RBI tonight for Nixon, 17 total on the season. Bernie to Jeter to Posada. And back to third base to get Nixon.
Now Veritek, who takes a pitch for a strike. Veritek grounded out to second. A moment ago I mentioned that the Red Sox have had the lead man on in every inning so far. Should also mention that all of them have scored. Damon Baerga and now Hillenbrand.
And his left-handed action now out in that bullpen for the Yankees. Sterling Hitchcock.
That's what it looks like. Chop to first. Giambi will need Clemens. Roger is there. Veritek down the line very nicely. Just nabbed at first. And there is the first, actually second out of the inning. Sterling Hitchcock warming up in the pen. And there's two down now in the third.
Number 10, walking back towards the designated hitter.
Run over the first. Here's Carlos Baerga, who singled off Clemens in the second and scored. And there for the strike. Baerga batting eighth tonight for the Red Sox and being used as the DH. Little's going to like what he has seen so far in this series. Victory last night, 3-1. And the great pitching of Pedro Martinez tonight. The offense right out of the gate getting Roger Clemens. And so far, 6 runs on 6 hits. 2-1 now to Baerga.
Now, Roger doesn't have that good splitter so far in this game tonight. Because of that, he's had to go with more fastball.
Chopped right side at Soriano. Takes it belt high. And Baerga's gone. So are the Red Sox. But they continue to put up the runs and grab another one here in the bottom of the third through three. 6-0 Boston. Nesson's exclusive coverage of Boston Red Sox baseball is brought to you in part by Heineken. It's all about the beer. Heineken. Don Orsillo and Jerry Remy back at Fenway. 6-0. Red Sox on top through three. Our producer Pat Cavanaugh, director Mike Naracci, associate producer Pat White, and Justin Duran. Assisting us in the booth as we head to the fourth. John Burkett has been very good tonight. Giambi out after the first one. Hits it deep and far to right center field. Damon looking up, and that ball is gone. Solo home run for Jason Giambi to open up the fourth inning. His 11th round tripper of the year as the Yankees on the board for the first time tonight.
Giambi picks up his 11th of the season, his third in his career against Burkett, right to that 420 sign out there in the triangle.
Number 20, the catcher, Jorge Posada.
Just to the right of the yellow line.
Some 420 feet away. Jorge Posada struck out looking his first time. The cheer you may have heard as he was rounding the bases. The fans out there threw the ball back under the outfield. Posada hits it on the ground to Sanchez. On to Offerman. One down.
You look out into that area where he hit the home run. There's a couple of signs out there, and between the signs is a yellow line. And that ball hit just about to the right of that yellow line. To the left, that ball's in play.
Just another of the nooks and crannies here at Fenway. If you go the other way into left center field by the 370 marker, that's another spot where you run into that yellow line type situation. just below the flag out there in left center.
Now, they used to have a net up there. I don't know if it's still there. This area right here.
You know, it's funny. It's kind of like when you were a kid and you'd set up, you know, if it hits the tree, it's this. If it's, I mean, it's kind of like that. You got the yellow lines. Yeah, there's your net.
Yeah, it's still there.
So it makes Fenway, Fenway. 1-1. That baffled him. 1-2 now to Ventura. Ventura's had back-to-back tough seasons coming into this year. Had shoulder surgery prior to 2000 and battled some ailments last year. Hamstring, hip, shoulder, hand problems a year ago. Played hurt. Strike three to Ventura. There's strikeout number six for John Burkett. Two down.
We've always talked about Burkett being a thinking man pitcher. Now, you remember last time up, he went away with the fastball to get Ventura for the strikeout. So Ventura thinking away. This time, tails the ball back on the corner, on the inside corner. So the guessing game continues between pitcher and hitter. That time, Burkett wins it.
John Vanderwall singled to right his first time. One of five hits for the Yankees. The hits department is very similar. The Red Sox are out hitting the Yankees 6-5, but the runs column is not. The Red Sox on top 6-1. The time called very late in the equation as Burkett is into his delivery again. Vanderwall came to the Yankees from the Giants in a trade for right-handed pitcher Jay Wataza. It was in October of last year. And is a very, very good pinch hitter. He ranks third on the all-time pinch hit home run list with 17 pinch hit home runs. Gets the start tonight for the Yankees in right field and is 1-for-1. Strike three over the outside corner. Back-to-back K's for Burkett. 7 in all. The Yankees grab a run on that man's 11th home run of the year. The end of 3.5 from Fenway. 6-1 Red Sox. Back at Fenway, 3.5 deep into this one with the Red Sox on top 6-1. Very productive early and often. 3 in the first, 2 in the second, 1 in the third. Garcia Parra, single RBI and a run. A couple of RBIs, actually. Nixon, a double, 2 ribbies. And Damon has been on base with 2 walks, 2 runs. See the tough line for Roger Clemens through the first 3. And Burkett, 2-4, striking out 7. After the first pitch, and lifting it into the gap in left center field is Ray Sanchez. He's thinking 2, maybe more, as Bernie Williams gets it back in. He'll pull up at second base with a leadoff double. And for the fourth consecutive inning, the Red Sox have the lead man on.
Now, Roger tried the slider that time against Sanchez, and Sanchez jumps all over it, finds that gap in left center field. Got a little rain falling right now at Fenway Park. Is there maybe a shower passing through the area?
There's some nasty-looking dark clouds off to our left. And the rain falling at Fenway. Here's Johnny Damon, who's walked twice, scored twice, also has a stolen base. This is away to Damon.
A couple of booths down from us, Jason Kidd was in that booth. I don't know if he's still there. It's the Yankee broadcast booth. Plus the Nets in town to play the Celtics tomorrow at 5:30.
Foul outside of first. What'd you say? You want to post up against him?
Yeah, I take him down low. Yep, post him up.
He's not as big as I thought he would be, but then again, one of the bigger players, but still. I didn't make the bold statement that I could take him. You did.
I just said I could post him up. I didn't say I could take him.
1-1 to Johnny Damon. Chopped right side. Soriano to his left towards the bag. Worked out pretty well for him. Backhanded it barehanded to get Damon. He's retired for the first time tonight, but ball to the right side. Sanchez on to third with one away.
Nice job by Johnny Damon to pull that ball, get a man to third base with less than two outs.
For the trivia question, what pitcher recorded the most wins after the age of 34? It'll be timely. We'll have the answer for you in the next half inning. Jose Offerman's 0 for 2. He reached on a two-base error last time up. Struck out in the first. Infield in all the way around. Yankees trying to preserve a five-run deficit. Offerman with a big sweeping cut, 1-1. Sox have scored in every inning so far as they again attempt to score some more. Sanchez at third, the strike to Offerman. Cleveland on top, 4-0. We've got Justin Miller. 1-2, grounded right side. Soriano will look the runner back and throw out Offerman. 4-3, and Sanchez remains at third with now two down.
That may have been the best splitter that the Rogers thrown so far in this game, and there's the frustration for leaving that man at third base from Jose Offerman. In this case, designed for either the strikeout or the ground ball. See that ball moving down and away. And the result, the ground ball to Soriano. Sanchez holds at third base.
Atlanta has a 2-0 lead tonight against Cincinnati. The return of Ken Griffey Jr. was cut by Nomar.
Another good splitter there.
Two outs and runners in scoring position. Nomar ranked second at 455. Shea right in behind him.
Griffey returning to the lineup hasn't exactly got people excited in Cincinnati.
No. Questions as to whether or not they really need him. Cincinnati Reds in first place by two games. They don't want to mess up what's been a great thing this year and kind of a surprise. 28-19, basically without him. And again, he took less money to go home to Cincinnati, but I'm not sure that the hometown kid has been embraced by his hometown.
I'd have taken more to go somewhere else.
A 1-2 pitch. Up and away, and the count is 2-2. So if there was a major league team in the Fall River area, and you had a chance to go.
No, they'd have to be in the ballpark.
Oh, and it's a full count, 3-2.
Those things haven't gone well there for him. He's been injured a lot. Certainly not the same player that they saw in the American League, the great player they saw in the American League.
Arguably the game's best player at one point. Grounded down the third baseline outside of the line of foul.
Yeah, that's a nice play.
So a new ball girl maybe down the third baseline tonight.
Weekends. Maybe they switch on weekends.
Omar's single, hit a sack fly, two RBIs, now 36 of the year. Trying to bring that man home, Ray Sanchez. On the ground, left side and through. He will indeed bring home Ray Sanchez. 7-1 Boston, Omar's third RBI of the night.
Well, a lot of guys who in the past have not had good success against Clemens certainly doing it tonight. Nomar with a couple of hits. We mentioned coming to the game, only a 107 average against Roger. Three RBIs and two hits. Gets the fastball between Ventura and Gita. And it's all Red Sox at this point. And the Red Sox fans are loving this.
And again, the Roger chant goes up at Fenway Park. Two down, runner at first for Dobbuck. Swings at the first pitch, hits it high and deep towards right center. Back by the triangle, Bernie's still going. That'll fall into the triangle. And up into the seats, a ground rule double. Unfortunate for the Red Sox because that will bring Nomar back to third. He would have scored. A double for Dobbuck as he sends it about as deep as you can without getting it out of the yard here at Fenway.
Yeah, Giambi's went about 430. This one will go about 410. And that's finally going to bring Joe out of the dugout. Wait till you hear this.
Certainly brings back memories to the playoffs a few years ago when Roger exited early. He's gotten into the fourth this time, but I'm sure the rude reception he will get once again. There he goes, and here comes the Fenway faithful to send him off. One Red Sox still in the midst of the bottom of the fourth. We'll step aside. Back at Fenway, Roger Clemens has been chased from tonight's contest. Red Sox on top 7-1, still in the midst of the last of the fourth inning. And we will check out the Aflac tribute question before we tell you about the new pitcher. What pitcher recorded the most wins after the age of 34? And the answer, Cy Young. Old Cy, 225 wins after the age of 34. And they got Phil Niekro in there at 221 in second, Lauren Spahn third. Here's the new pitcher, he's Sterling Hitchcock.
Just recently came off the disabled list. That was back on May 9th. He was on the DL with a lower back strain. It's only his fourth appearance of the year. He's made one start, the record of 1-0. He's only pitched 10 innings, 14 hits allowed, 6 walks, and 7 strikeouts.
Clemens worked 3 2/3 innings, surrendering 9 hits. So far, 7 runs. 5 of the 7 are earned due to the error by Robin Ventura in the second inning. He walked 2 and struck out 2. And is still responsible for Daubach and Garcia Parra, who are on. Hillenbrand at 480 against left-handers, and he will not have a chance to face Hitchcock. They'll intentionally walk Shea Hillenbrand with first base vacant. It won't be for long. Shea had been 2-for-2 against Roger Clemens with a pair of singles, one to the outfield and one of the infield variety. But they'll take the bat out of his hands this time. And they'll go after Trout Nixon, of course, the lefty-lefty matchup with Hitchcock now on. Just another note on that Aflac tribute question, the most wins after the age of 34. A couple knuckleballers have done very well. Niekro at 221, Charlie Hoff at 143 wins after the age of 34. And Roger Clemens has 104 wins after the age of 34. Turned 34 and 96 last year in Boston. Here is Trout Nixon. The base is loaded, 2 down, a run already in. In there for the strike over the outside corner. It had stopped raining for a few moments, but it has begun to rain again. Red Sox are very much, at the very least, like to get through the fifth inning here, as it's been raining runs. 7-1 Boston. 1-1 now to Nixon.
First beach ball of the game out there in center field, causing the delay.
Bases loaded, 2 down. And the 1-1 to Nixon. Off speed, drops in there for the strike. Nasty pitch, 1-2. Hitchcock came to the Yankees in a trade from San Diego. In exchange for outfielder Darren Blakely and pitcher Brett Jody. Signed a 2-year deal that has him here next year as well for New York.
Had some mom problems out there, I believe, in San Diego.
The 1-2 pitch. Nixon grounds it foul. Speaking of a former Yankees and Red Sox pitcher, David Cohn has announced he's going to be joining the Yankees Yes Network coming up. And apparently he's going to not be coming back as a pitcher this year, but he said that they'd wait and see if he would end up somewhere. Of course, the Red Sox could have talked to him after May 1st. Apparently he's coming back to broadcast with the Yankees Network. Up and in sends Nixon barreling out of the box, 2-2. David Cohn visited here
and was sitting out in the bleachers here at Fenway. There's that fastball high and tight to Trot Nixon. It's going to be on the pregame show, postgame show.
I think so.
I think
yeah.
Paul O'Neill's also doing some work for him.
And Joe Kerrigan, former Red Sox manager, doing some work for the Philadelphia Phillies. Telecast. A 2-2. Low and inside to Nixon. Runs full. Nowhere to put him. Bases loaded, two outs, and of course the runners with two outs and a full count will be off. Nobody at third, Daubach at second, Hillenbrand at first, and again Fenway comes to its feet, already on top, 7-1, looking for more. Hitchcock ready. The runners are off the payoff pitch. In the air to center field. Bernie Williams backing up, has it sized up. Wynn plays with it, but Williams takes care of it. Red Sox will leave them loaded. They push across another run. We've played four from Fenway. 7-1 Red Sox. Don Orsillo and Jerry Remy back at Fenway Park. Through four, 7-1. Red Sox on top. They've scored in every inning so far. And have chased Roger Clemens from the game. As we head to the fifth, Rondell White, Nick Johnson, and Alfonso Soriano expected in the inning. Rondell White at 228 as one of five Yankees hits. The breaking ball swung on and missed. He's in the hole, nothing in two. Burkett has thrown 50 pitches as he misses with 51. He is in pretty good shape here in terms of pitch count as he works into the fifth. Threw just 9 pitches in the fourth inning. Getting the call this time on the corner, 2-2.
They tried that same spot again, but that time just a little bit more outside.
7 strikeouts tonight for John Burkett. The 2-2. On the ground at Hillenbrand. Came up off the lip of the grass. Shea throws out Rondell White for the first out of the fifth. Let's check in with Tom Karen out of the bleachers. Tom?
All right, Don, thanks very much. A great rivalry, obviously, Red Sox-Yankees, but some things transcend that. Tonight we're here with firefighters, some from... as guests here of the Massport Fire Department. Rob Ostrowski from the New York Fire Department. Talk about this weekend.
Well, the Massport Fire Department offered us a trip to Boston to come out and see two games tonight and tomorrow day, and flew us out here and put us up in a hotel, and a bunch of us took advantage of it, and it's just been a great time. We're having a great time, and you know, obviously it's all in memory of everybody we lost on September 11th, so it's a little bittersweet, but we're all having a really good time.
Chris Doyle from the Massport Fire Department. You got the nice score, so it's a great weekend so far.
Yep, things are going great here for the Bo Sox, but even better for us than the FDNY and the Massport Fire Department. We're having a great time, and we're glad to have these guys up here.
Talk about FDNY and what it means to have those guys here tonight.
They're super good guys. They've always been really good to us when we go down to the big city, and we just wanted to extend our appreciation to them and bring them up here for Yankees-Red Sox game and have a great weekend with them, fellow firefighters.
Doing that, guys, thanks very much. Yankee fans and Red Sox fans, and together in harmony, guys.
Very nice. Thank you, TC. That's great.
They threw out the first ball, didn't they, tonight?
Yes, they did, yeah. And they received a very nice hand from the Red Sox fans here. How about being in the bleachers this weekend? Wow. That is all I can say. Talking to some of the policemen coming up in the elevator, and they said that last night was like nothing they've seen before out there in the bleachers.
Well, it's always extra special, obviously, when New York comes to town, and there has been quite a bit of a back and forth in the bleachers throughout the years in the Boston-New York series.
Johnson out after the 1-2, floats it into shallow center. Garcia Parra out number two.
Now, John Burkett's control tonight has been absolutely outstanding. He's putting every pitch just about the exact spot that he wants to. Little cut fastball that time, get it in the hands of Johnson, tied him up for the pop-up.
Those gentlemen have to be very pleased with what they have seen offensively from the Red Sox, and from a pitching standpoint as well. Burkett has struck out more here tonight than he has ever before as a member of the Red Sox. Previous high had been 6 Ks. He's got 7 tonight, including a strikeout of the gentleman at the plate, Alfonso Soriano, back in the first inning. You will want to join Extra Innings in the postgame. Pedro Martinez will be joining the Extra Innings crew after this one. Off the end of the bat, foul, right side, 0-2 to Soriano.
Knowing that Soriano likes to chase pitches, as we take a look at Pedro, let's see how Burkett works him now ahead in the count 0-2. Probably won't even throw him anything close to the plate.
Mentioned that he struck out 125 times last year. That one misses. Soriano's still just 24 years old, and there are some, after his 43 steals last year, who feel he could be a 40-40 man at some point in his career. A candidate to do it. Now 1-2. In the air, lofted to center field. Damon coming on, but it will fall. Not hit hard, but golfed into center field. Second hit of the night for Soriano.
At the curveball that time from Burkett, the slow curveball right toward the end of the bat, but drops it in the center field for the base hit. And Soriano certainly is a terrific player, and if he ever gets to a point where he's able to cut down on his strikeouts, he'll be an even better player. But what great natural talent.
Derek Jeter 0-for-2 tonight. He struck out in the first, bounced into a double play in the third. So he has been stymied by John Burkett. But he's not alone in that category tonight for the Yankees.
Jeter right now working on a 14-game hitting streak.
Going away, and it's now 2-0. Jeter did not go after the first pitch. Last year had a very good year going out after the first pitch. He hit 437 with 7 home runs out after that first pitch given up by a pitcher. But he has been patient here ahead 2-0. Soriano always a threat to take off. In the air to right center field. That'll fall for a base hit. Soriano touches second. He's headed for third as Nixon gathers it out in right center field. The Yankees trying to get something going with 2 down.
Well, Jeter does continue the hitting streak now at 15 games with the base hit to the opposite field. Watch how Jeter pulls the hands inside the baseball, gets the good part of the bat on it. It's an inside-out stroke for Derek Jeter. I was thinking about Roger leaving the ball game this early. He has been known in the past, after being taken out of a game, to go for a jog or a sprint. And it would not be uncommon to see him somewhere around the Charles River.
Certainly knows the area well enough
to do a workout. I'll tell you, he's done that in the past.
To run off the frustration from tonight. Well, this Yankees team made many changes during the offseason. And they're without very good clubhouse guys. Not to say they didn't add very good clubhouse guys, but Scott Brosius, Tino Martinez, Paul O'Neill. Some pretty key factors to the championship runs the Yankees have had. And I don't know if they're better or worse with these moves, because they have definitely brought in great players. And Joe Torre, of course, a terrific manager.
Well, the 31-17 coming into the game, and if it hadn't been for the great start of the Red Sox, I mean, that's a pretty good record. So there's still a long, long way to go.
There are 11 players left from the 2000 championship. So a great deal of turnover. You see Joe Torre, he's the fourth man to manage both the Mets and Yankees. Casey Stengel, Yogi Berra, Dallas Green, also managing both New York clubs. Line to center field, that'll fall for a base hit and bring in a run. Soriano jogs in from third. The third consecutive hit for the Yankees with two outs here in the fifth leads to their second run, now 7-2 Boston.
A couple of quick outs for John Burkett, then three straight base hits. Soriano, Jeter, and now Bernie Williams on the curveball. Two hits in the inning on the curveball, one by Soriano and one by Bernie Williams. Bernie picks up his 25th RBI of the season. It's a five-run game.
Well, here's the cornerstone of the moves that the Yankees made during the offseason. Bring in Jason Giambi. Homered in the fourth, his 11th of the year, 1-for-2 tonight. In there for the strike over the inside corner. Here are the home run leaders in the month of May. Williams has 8, Giambi with 7. Alfonso Soriano with 6. The Yankees leading the American League in home runs. And the Yankees were held without a home run for the second straight game last night. Of course, they homered tonight. And at one point, they had homered in 14 straight games.
Yeah, that stopped, I believe, the last game against Minnesota. Day game at Yankee Stadium.
I think you're correct. 75 home runs through 49 games now for the Yankees. They have 17 more than the second highest team in the major leagues in that category. The Arizona Diamondbacks with 57. So they are far and away the leader in the major leagues. The 2-1. Randy gets the hands out of the way and takes ball three. Burkett has had to throw 23 pitches in this inning, 71 now in the outing, and he's got a full count.
And no fastball there on the 3-1 count. Burkett goes to the changeup and had Giambi off balance. Burkett may not even throw it on the side. He may have just talked about what pitch they want to throw on the 3-2 count.
Runners will be in motion with two outs. Those runners, Jeter at second, Williams at first. Pretty good speed on the base pass. And the payoff pitch. And the dirt ball four. There's the first walk of the night given up by John Burkett. And that'll get Tony Cloninger on the phone for the first time tonight.
And after the phone call, a little conversation between the pitching coach and John Burkett. Give that guy in the bullpen a chance to get a few throws in. A.C. Fossum, the lefty, first man out of the bullpen tonight.
So John Burkett has run into some trouble here in the fifth after really extremely good first four innings of three innings of shutout pitching. He gave up the leadoff home run to Jason Giambi in the fourth. Struck out 7 Yankees through the first four innings, but got the first two outs of this inning quickly in Rondell White and Nick Johnson. 3 singles and a walk later, the Yankees have another run to their total and have the bases loaded with 2 down. And their switcher and catcher, Jorge Posada, is next. In there for strike 1-2, Posada. started tonight batting fifth, and he's done a lot of that this season. Last year, primarily batting from the sixth and seventh spots. Low, and it's 1-1. John Burkett trying to keep his perfect record as a member of the Red Sox, coming in at 5-0 into tonight's action. 2.57 earned run average and his seventh appearance of the year. Has a 5-run lead as he works in the top of the fifth. Jeter at third, Williams at second, Giambi at first. 2-1 now to Posada. Red Sox leading the league in earned run average coming into tonight, 3.21 as a club. The Yankees are second at 3.59. Grounded and caught by Offerman in a hop. He'll run to the bag and take it along. The Yankees will leave them loaded. They do push across the run in the top of the fifth inning. But at the end of four and a half, 7-2 Red Sox.
Back at Fenway, the Red Sox have a 7-2 lead here in the bottom of the fifth. Well, H.P. Hood is rooting for the Red Sox and kids throughout New England. Each time the Red Sox strike out an opponent, make a double play, or hit a home run at Fenway, Hood donates $100 to the Hood Home Team Advantage Fund. So far, more than $19,000 has been raised for children's hospitals all over New England. Thank you, Grammy, for getting those tickets. They're enjoying the ball game. From Maine. How did Grammy get the tickets? Oh, she's watching, right?
I would guess
that. She got the tickets.
Yeah.
I think she slept in line, you know, like they put them on sale in January and they camp out for like two nights. Maybe Grammy was camping out to get tickets to the Yankee game.
You would probably have to camp out to get tickets for this series. Jason Veritek 0 for 2. He's grounded out twice. And the strike evens the count at 1-1. Omar Garciaparra has two hits. Brian Daubach has two. Hillenbrand with two. This is lined into left field. Veritek will have his first hit of the night. Well, the Red Sox, for the fifth consecutive inning, you have the lead man on.
Veritek really been swinging the bat well from the right side of the plate. 300 batting average going into that at bat. 10 hits now and 31, hitting right-handed. Line shot quickly by Robin Ventura for the hit. Red Sox now with 10 in the ball game.
Baerga will turn around now and bat from the right side against the left-hander Hitchcock. The line on Clemens tonight, 3 2/3. He gave up 9 hits, 7 runs. 5 of the 7 are earned runs. The error by Ventura back in the second inning, making 2 of the runs unearned. Walked 2, struck out 2, and Roger threw 85 pitches tonight. He's on the hook right now. Erga with a big cut, evens the count at 1-1. Nice gesture today by Derek Lowe, who I understand Grady Little was talking about it before the ball game. Handed out watches to all of his teammates, commemorating the no-hitter that he threw here at Fenway Park. And on the silver watch, it has the no-hitter date, the team they played, which was Tampa Bay, and the fact that it was a no-hitter. Grady also mentioned that Jason Veritek is battery mate, and the no-hitter got an upgrade on his watch. And a very nice gesture from Derek Lowe. Now 1-1. Cut again from Baerga, 1-2. Derek Lowe will be starting tomorrow in the matinee game. Lowe looking for his eighth win of the year, 7-1. He'll go against David Wells, who has been ailing a little bit with a back problem. Lefty 6-1, scheduled to go tomorrow. Then Darren Oliver, who's had very good success against the Yankees over the course of his career, goes against Mike Mussina, and that's the Sunday night game on ESPN. Tomorrow on Fox 25.
Did he get that game up in Canada? They must, right?
Yeah, I think you can, yeah.
Yeah, good. I'll already be up there in Toronto waiting for them to come in, so I'll get a chance to watch that. Joe Morgan and Johnny Miller here for the ESPN Sunday night game.
The 2-2. Up and away, and it's a full count. It's begun raining again here at Fenway. Right off and on a few times tonight. Carlos Baerga batting, nobody out. Bottom of the fifth inning, Jason Veritek stands at first. Held on by Jason Giambi. And a strikeout caught in no man's land is Veritek. The throw to first is not going to be in time. For whatever reason, Posada hesitated. I don't know if he double pumped or what he did, but Veritek able to get back to the bag at first. He was hung up between first and second. He may have hurt himself getting back into the bag.
I think what happened to Posada is he got hooked up with Baerga. Now, Baerga swings and misses on an outside pitch, crosses the plate, and then they bump a little bit, but it just took too long for Posada to decide where to make that throw. Does he go to second or to first? And by the time he gets rid of it, it's too late. Boy, hard slide back into first base. Veritek lucky to sprain an ankle.
He was looking around there for a moment, but it appears he is all right, staying in there at first. Sanchez lifts it in the air down the right field line. Vanderwall onto the dirt to make the catch for the inning second out.
Veritek still limping, and he's telling the trainer to stay in the dugout.
And then Harper now has called time, and I think he's trying to get Jim Rowe to come out as he looks over his shoulder.
See Veritek here. Looks all right. There's where he turned the ankle over. You could see that right ankle turn over when he stopped between first and second. Then he had to slide back into the bag at the same ankle.
And Jim Rowe poised and ready should they ask him to head out there.
Nice job by our camera crew to catch that.
Johnny Damon's walked twice, scored twice. Also has a stolen base. Grounded out. Lays it down the left field line, but that'll end up foul.
Yeah, Veritek clearly limping as he heads back into first base. He may have to come out of the game, get some ice on that thing. No, he's not coming out.
No, he's not.
I'm not coming out. No way I'm coming out. You will, too, come out. No, I'm not coming out.
That's the third head shake I've seen. I don't know how many we've missed. Tommy Harper tried to get Jim Rowe to come out. A 1-1 pitch. Damon grounds it towards Jeter. He'll go the easy way to second, and Veritek sliding into second base. The out there. Red Sox are gone in the fifth, the first inning in which they have not scored. We're through five. 7-2 Boston.
Back at Fenway, 7-2, Red Sox lead as we go to the top of the sixth. Let's take a look at the stolen base leaders around baseball, brought to you by Mobile Speed Pass. Kenny Lofton of Chicago with 19, Ichiro with 15, Johnny Damon 13, and Beltran 13. In the National League, that Juan Pierre, he's still in second place, one behind Luis Castillo and Alex Sanchez third. We're going to see Juan Pierre this year as the Rockies will make a visit to Fenway Park in interleague play.
Right, the Diamondbacks coming here as well. We will go to San Diego and Los Angeles, not this trip, but a trip after that.
And Atlanta also.
Yeah. Our natural rival. The only team we won't play in the West is the San Francisco Giants. Ventura to lead it off as we head to the top of the sixth inning. John Burkett had to expend the most energy that he has had to expend in any inning tonight in the fifth. The Yankees got a run. They left the bases loaded. And they've left six men on through the first five. Burkett's now thrown 79 pitches in his outing. And right now, no action in the pen.
Well, there is action. Doug Mirabelli is throwing down there. So just in case Veritek has problems with that ankle, Mirabelli would be coming into the game.
Rio in there for a strike to Ventura. Had struck out twice against Burkett tonight in two previous at bats. This time he grounds out to first. It is 0 for 3 tonight.
Number 28, the right fielder, John.
Mentioned earlier, the longest outing for John Burkett, 7 innings back on May 3rd at Tropicana Field in Tampa Bay. The Sox winning that game 3-2. Otherwise, he's been led around 5 or 6. The shortest outing John's had is 5 innings. Done that twice. 5 1/3 so far tonight for him as John Vanderwall takes strike one. Up top to go after that pitch, and he finds himself in the hole, nothing in two. Two games left with the Yankees tomorrow and Sunday. Then the Red Sox head to Toronto. And then they will play the Yankees over the following weekend in New York. First trip of the year to Yankee Stadium. This, of course, the second time the Yankees have been here. And it was interesting before the game. Rotation is unchanged as it stands now. Pedro Martinez would not face the Yankees at all next weekend in New York. And Greg Little said that he would not rearrange the rotation. At least that's his thinking at this point, to have Pedro pitch against the Yankees. So Pedro will pitch against Toronto in his next outing.
Yeah, Red Sox have an off day between the Toronto and New York series. Next Thursday is an off day for the Red Sox.
The 2-2 to Vanderwall. And on the fist, out towards right center field, Damon, two down.
Now that's the way last inning started. Couple of quick outs for Burkett. Then the Yankees were able to score a run.
Number 27.
John's going to try to not let that happen this inning.
Rondell White.
Here's Rondell White, 1 for 2. A single in the second inning, grounded out to third base in the fifth.
Any celebrities here tonight?
Well, we saw Kraft here tonight.
Jason Kidd.
How about James Taylor stopping in with you last night? I was very envious. Line to left. Ryan Dombach has that get up over his head. It'll one-hop the wall. There's the ricochet quickly. And gets it back in quickly. Rondell White hitting it hard. Held to just a single.
Now that was hit hard. That's for sure. That was like a line drive going over a third baseman's head instead of left field. Quick hop off the wall and only a single for Rondell White. Not much reaction time for Dawback, and that's unusual in left field. Hey, where's Billy Crystal? He's a big Yankee fan, isn't he, around?
Yeah. Did that movie 61, which was on HBO. We'll see all those guys when we get to New York. I'm sure Rudy will be there, among others. We always complain on a Donald Trump sighting at Yankee Stadium. Yeah, James Taylor last night. That had to be fun. You get a chance to talk to James?
Actually, I sang to him.
Oh, God. I heard some of your singing last night. Could do without a little bit more. Kind of ruined it for me as a James Taylor fan. I hadn't quite heard some of my favorite songs the way you sang them.
Now, mine sound a little bit different, but you know, when you're in the shower and you're singing, it all sounds good, right?
Right. One and one the count. on the ground at Offerman. He'll take care of it alone. The Yankees strand another. 5.5 done from Fenway Park. Red Sox 7, Yankees 2. Don Orsillo and Jerry Remy back at Fenway Park. We're 5.5 deep. Red Sox on top 7-2. And as they come to the plate in the last of the sixth inning, Offerman, Garcia Parra, and Brian Daubach scheduled to face Sterling Hitchcock, who has been on since the fourth inning in relief of Roger Clemens. Offerman lines it to center. Bernie Williams without number one. Sterling Hitchcock in his second go-around with the New York Yankees. He was originally drafted by the Yankees in the ninth round in 1989 and was with New York from 92 through 95 the first time. Came back last year, made 9 starts and 10 appearances and was 4-4. He was acquired by the Yankees for a couple of minor league players from the San Diego Padres. Best years perhaps spent in San Diego. Nomar hits it high and deep to left. White looking up. Can you say home run? Yes, you can. Nomar Garcia Parra, his 6th of the year, and the Red Sox lead it 8-2.
Not a bad night for Nomar. 3 hits, 4 RBI. Once again, first ball hitting. That fastball led a high and finds the screen in left field for the home run. Giambi with a home run. Garcia Parra with a home run.
Well, Nomar's 3 hits tonight. He's now toting a .316 batting average. Brian Daubach. Ryan has 2 hits tonight, a single, a double, struck out looking against Clemens. Roger had only 2 strikeouts tonight. Offerman and Daubach both down by way of the K. 1-1 now to Daubach. Hits are 11-9. Favor of the Red Sox. More disparity in the run column, though. 8-2, Red Sox on top. Hitchcock with the 1-1. Inside.
Hitchcock's fastball only registering about 84, 85 miles an hour.
Said before, he has a splitter also that he features.
Yeah, breaking ball, changeup, splitter. I don't think with the surgery he had, was it elbow surgery, shoulder? He was at the end of his career there in San Diego.
He was the opening day starter in 2000 for the Padres as the late strike call has Daubach miffed. Yeah, he began the 2001 season with a 60-day DL with San Diego. He had Tommy John surgery.
Hey, elbow surgery.
May 30th of 2000, he went on the DL. He's coming back from Tommy John. Opposite field liner, but White's there, shy of the dirt of the track. 2 down. Trey Hillenbrand has been on base 3 times tonight. He was the first hitter that Sterling Hitchcock faced when he came on in relief of Roger Clemens. And at the time, they opted to intentionally walk him. Yep, walk the bases loaded, then Nixon fly to center to end the inning. So it worked out all right for the Yankees. Prior to that, Hillenbrand singled to the outfield, singled in the infield. 2 hits and an RBI tonight for Shea Hillenbrand. And Sterling Hitchcock, best year he had with the Yankees, 11-10 in 95 is last year. Next year he had his best year ever in terms of wins, was 13-9 with the Mariners in 96. Had a higher run average, 5.35. And 10 wins with the Padres the next year, 9 in 98, 12-14 in 99. This is lined into left center field. It'll get down track and the wall. Hillebrand still running will head up into second base with his third hit of the night. It's a double with two down in the bottom of the sixth inning.
Every ball that's been hit this inning has been hit hard. A line drive by Offerman right at Bernie Williams. Obviously the home run by Nomar. A line drive by Dalbach at Rondell White. And now this line drive in the gap for the double. So Hillenbrand, who started the game at 320, ninth in the league in hitting, will probably move up a little bit.
Here comes Nixon, who doubled in the third, was thrown out at third base. And a move over as a throw went to the plate. So Hillenbrand was able to score, but Nixon was thrown out at third base after his double. He's grounded to short and has fly to center. First base vacant with Hillenbrand standing at second. Rolling away, and it's now 1-1.
Hillenbrand's average now has climbed to 331 with the three hits tonight.
On the ground towards Giambi. He will take it to the bag alone, and that'll do it in the sixth. Red Sox add a run. Home run number six of the year for Nomar Garciaparra. Red Sox on top of this one, 8-2.
Coverage begins at 6:30, only on NESN.
Forget about that one. He is out. On to first base, double play. Throw to second, and they get him.
Thursday, May 30th at 7. The Paw Sox welcome the Columbus Clippers to McCoy Stadium, only on NESN.
Tell you what, my old job, I really had to rely on getting a good call.
And he struck him out.
Now it's your turn to make the call.
Tune in Red Sox Digest, NESN's half-hour pregame show, and Extra Innings, our expanded postgame show. Former Sox reliever Jim Corsi joins Bob Rogers to preview the games, analyze the outcome, and take your phone calls live.
It's Red Sox coverage you won't find anywhere else, so tune in, call up, and ask NESN.
Back at Fenway, we go to the top of the seventh, an 8-2 Red Sox lead. Will Sox fans take a break this summer and enjoy a weekend in Boston with the Marriott Copley Place Triple Play Package? Your package includes a room for two nights, breakfast, and two tickets to a Red Sox game at Fenway. Call 877-901-2079 to make your reservations today.
Top of the seventh inning, John Burkett back out there again. 92 pitches deep into his outing. I would imagine that if he can work his way through this inning, this would be it for John. He can make quick work of the Yankees. As the inning begins, the Red Sox have Fossum up in the bullpen. Soriano's first. He's 2-for-3 tonight. And they have another hit deep and far to left center field. Damon looking up, and that's gone. Into the screen and out of the yard. Second home run of the night for the Yankees. The 12th home run of the year for 24-year-old Alfonso Soriano. And it's now 8-3 Boston.
Well, he is wiry. He is very strong and very, very quick wrists. Watch his wrist on this swing. Just generates some power and that up into the screen in left center field.
home runs already for Soriano on the season, matching that number on his back.
Said it earlier, he may be a candidate to be a 40-40 man before he is done. Derek Jeter with a big cut. You mentioned the term wiry. He's all sorts of flexible, not big, strong, and, you know. Not a lot to him. He's not weak by any means, certainly strong. Not overly put together. Like Jose Canseco say.
Not overly put together.
Well, you know what I'm saying?
No, I get your point.
Yeah, just I'm all around where I want to be. I'm sort of on the periphery of.
He's not a muscle. He's got a muscle there.
That's what I'm trying to say. I'm sort of all the way around. It got very wordy too. The 0-2 pitch to Derek Jeter. In the center field, Ron Burkett not liking the way that the seventh inning is beginning. A home run and now a single. And he's not going to like this anymore as Brady Little is headed out from the dugout. On the second hit for Jeter, will spell the end of John Burkett's night. He should get a great hand as he heads off. In line to pick up victory number 6 without a loss. And he's turned in another fine effort here tonight against an extremely good Yankees lineup. And that'll do it for John. And Fenway will let him know how they feel. Seven pitches for John Burkett tonight. He leaves with a man on in the seventh inning and an 8-3 lead. He'll turn things over to the lefty, Casey Fawcett. We'll tell you about him when we come back. 8-3 Boston.
John Burkett leaves the game to a standing ovation from the friendly Fenway crowd. Yankees trail the Red Sox 8-3 here in the top of the seventh. Well, Sox fans, it's the year to be here, and now is your chance to be here. Seats are still available for games in June and July against Colorado, Toronto, and Detroit. The tickets call 617-482-4SOX or log on to redsox.com.
Well, John Burkett gone after 6-plus innings, and Casey Fossum into the game.
Fossum making his 17th appearance of the season. The record stands at 2 wins and no losses. His last against Seattle on the 17th. Inning and 2/3 in that game. A hit and a strikeout for Casey.
Ernie Williams turns around, bats from the right side against the left-handed pitcher. Ernie 2-for-3, a single, a double, and a run driven in. Pretty much the complete package. Last year, oddly enough, did not win Gold Glove for the first time in 5 years. Last year, for the 5th year in a row, named an All-Star. He was in the 4th spot for a lot of last year, but Tino Martinez had such a hot year last year. His final year for the Yankees kind of pushed him out of that spot. Ready bats 3rd, Jason Giambi pushed him out of that spot this season. Oakland winning 1-0 on a solo home run from Oakland Scott Hatterberg. Going to the right to the Oakland A's. The A's undergoing many changes, sending out Carlos Pena, who's here at Fenway Park. Jeff Tam, Frank Benettino, and training Jason Giambi's brother, Jeremy Giambi. Now, Oakland turned it around last year after a relatively similar start. They were a great second half and, of course, got into the postseason, but they're in last place in the AL West, 20-26 and 10 games out already. And they're mixing it up in a hurry out there. Rounded through the left side into left field for a base hit. Jeter up to 2nd. And the Yankees trying to get something going here in the top of the 7th. They already have a run in and now 2-1 and nobody out.
And Bernie Williams with 3 hits tonight, a double, a couple of singles, an RBI. No shortage of hits for the Yankees, that's for sure. 11 in the game. Actually, I think I gypped them 1 hit. 12 in the game.
Well, they've equaled the total of the Red Sox, both teams with 12 hits. Burkett responsible for Jeter at second. As Giambi swings away, pops it up, foul ground. Playable for Hillenbrand. Makes the catch. First look, I didn't think that was going to be playable, but Hillenbrand makes the catch and foul ground. Giambi is out number one.
Again, it's one of those high pop-ups. When it gets above the roof boxes here at Fenway, the wind takes over, and that wind blowing it back toward the field of play.
Number 20, the catcher, Jorge Posada.
Pretty gusty still, blowing out toward the bleacher area, toward the bullpens. That Canadian wind coming down again. It's going to cool things off tomorrow.
The good old north wind. There's Jorge Posada. 0-for-3, struck out looking in the second. Grounded out in the fourth and again in the fifth. Boy, most of the Yankees production tonight has come from the top three hitters as Posada lifts it in the air to right. Nixon underneath it, makes the catch, two down. To further that point, the top three hitters for the Yankees have 8 hits. Soriano, the top hitter with 3 hits. Leadoff man, Bernie Williams with 3 hits, and Jeter with 2.
The third baseman, Robin Ventura.
John Burkett went 6-plus innings tonight, giving up 11 hits. And I guess you can call him scattered, where he only give up 3 runs so far. He's still responsible for Jeter at second. He walked 1 and struck out 7. And has a chance to pick up his 6th win without a loss. Another fine effort tonight from John Burkett. And 97 pitches in his outing tonight. Ventura is 0-for-3, struck out twice and grounded out.
6-0 start for Burkett would be his first since 1993.
Awesome in the hole, 3-0. Really little talking today about the bullpen, and if there is any rustiness in the bullpen, it is because of the great job the starters have done, and guys who are used to getting a lot of work just aren't. As on 4 pitches, a walk to Robin Ventura to load the bases with 2 down.
Now Vanderwall's going to get called back. Shane Spencer will probably come out of that dugout, or Coomer, one of the two.
Pitch hitting last night for Nick Johnson in the 8th inning.
And we'll see if Brady, once he's announced into the game, will go get the right-hander Gossis, who's been loosening up.
Number 47, Shane Spencer.
Shane Spencer announced, and Brady making his way to the mound. So the Yankees with the bases loaded and 2 down in the 7th. They already have a run on the home run by Soriano. The Red Sox will be changing pitchers. That'll do it for Casey Fossum, and the Red Sox will use their 3rd pitcher of the inning here in the 7th. Still in the midst of the 7th. 8-3 Boston.
Eight to three Red Sox lead here in the top of the 7th inning. We remind you this copyrighted telecast presented by authority of the Boston Red Sox may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form, and the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the Boston Red Sox.
Casey Fossum done after 2/3 of an inning. And the Red Sox will use their 3rd arm of the night, Rich Garces.
Garces making his 14th appearance of the season, the 4th of this homestand. His last outing was against the White Sox a couple of days ago. He worked an inning in that game, did have a strikeout. Overall for Rich, 9 strikeouts in 12 innings. Opponents hitting .267.
The runners that are on, one still the responsibility of John Burkett, who went 6-plus innings. The other, Bernie Williams at second base. Now Fossum's problem, as well as Robin Ventura, who's at first. So the book is not closed on Burkett or Fossum as the Red Sox employ their 3rd pitcher of the top of the 7th inning. Shane Spencer hitting for John Vanderwall. 291, two homers and 11 runs driven in for Shane Spencer. He's not played in the last three games for the Yankees. Has been hot, six hits in his last nine at bats, despite not playing the last three games for the Yankees. Looking away, ball one.
Spencer in his career 0 for 3 against El Guapo. There you see his career pinch hitting numbers.
The 1-0 from Garces. 2-0. The Yankees left the bases loaded in the fifth inning. Here they have the bases loaded in the seventh with two down. Garces trying to throw his first strike since being summoned from the pen. Spencer taking all the way and the recipient at strike one. A 333 hitter with the bases loaded, three grand slams in his career. The 3-1 up and away, ball four, and Garces walks in a run. Jeter will come from third with the fourth Yankee run, and it's now 8-4 Boston as the Yankees cut the Boston lead in half.
No action in the bullpen for Grady Little. One base hit here and the Yankees are right back in this game.
Second walk of the inning, the third relinquished by Boston pitching. That will close the book on John Burkett, who in six plus innings gave up 11 hits and was charged with four runs. Walked one, struck out seven, but I'm quite sure he's more concerned with the victory than the overall numbers tonight. Eighth hitter of the inning for the Yankees is Rondell White. He takes strike one. Two for three from his number eight spot in the Yankees order. Sliced foul off the right side and he's in the hole, nothing in two. This at bat going, his sequence going much better for Rich Garces than it did with Shane Spencer already. Williams at third, Ventura at second, Spencer at first. And the 0-2 from Garces. Check swing, did he go? No, says Jim Reynolds, the first base umpire. Now the 1-2. Up at 2-2.
Pretty good job by Rondell White. He's laid off a couple of pretty good breaking balls by Garces.
Veritek will head to the mound to talk to Garces. The inning began with a solo home run by Alfonso Soriano. The leadoff hitter is 12th of the year. The Yankees added another run, most recently with the bases loaded when Shane Spencer, the pinch hitter, walked in. Derek Jeter. Yankees trailing 8-4. Bases loaded. Two outs. Top of the seventh inning. Garces with the 2-2. In the air. Not hit well, but well placed. It'll land in left center. And the Yankees will score two more and get back within two. Just a flare. And it's a two-run game now. 8-6 Red Sox.
Well, Garces tried three straight breaking balls. He wouldn't bite on the ones away. This one stays out over the plate. And Rondell White picks up his third hit of the night. Watch location of this curveball. Just stayed inside, right toward the end of the bat for White. But drops it in front of Johnny Damon. All of a sudden, you get an 8-6 ball game.
A and a tough left-hitting customer, Nick Johnson, the designated hitter for the Yankees coming up. Johnson, who last year was the number one prospect of the Yankees organization at the beginning of the year, and by year's end, participating in the World Series as a member of the Yankees.
And Wakefield in that bullpen trying to get ready in a hurry.
The runs that have scored here, the last two runs charged to Fossum, will be charged with two runs over two-thirds of an inning. The book now closed on him. Through the left side of the left field for a base hit. The Yankees will move closer now within a run. It's 8-7. Johnson, the number nine hitter, drives in the seventh Yankee run.
Well, Garcia has been having problems all season long, and they certainly continue here tonight. Starts off with the walk to bring in a run. The curveball hit for a base hit by White to drive in two, and now Johnson to the opposite field on the sinker. See Nomar playing him up the middle, expecting to pull the ball, just goes with the pitch and picks up the base hit, so the Yankees have battled all the way back to trail this by only one.
Tony Cloninger heading to the mound. And this also allows more time for Tim Wakefield, who's up in the pen. John Burkett went six plus, as you see Wakefield. Burkett giving up four runs and a chance to pick up his sixth victory, left with a sizable lead, but things have gotten much more interesting here as the Yankees have put a five spot on the board in the seventh, and they're not done yet. Two outs. Rondell White at second, Nick Johnson at first. And Alfonso Soriano, who began the inning with a home run, sends one to the gap in left center field. Damon's on the run. He'll run it down back on the dirt of the track. So the Yankees come up with five in the seventh inning, back within a run. Seventh inning, stretch time, 8-7 Boston. Back at Fenway Park, and another happy recipient of $100 we did see on TV tonight from Fenway. Let's check out the Heineken What's on Tap. The Yankees, of course, here tomorrow and Sunday. Matinee affair on Saturday, Fox 25. ESPN's Game of the Week on Sunday night. The conclusion of the 13-game homestand. Then it's off north of the border to Toronto. First two games on Fox 25. We're back with you on Wednesday. Our coverage beginning at 6:30 from Sky Dome. Shane Spencer takes over in right field after pinch hitting for John Vanderwall. And he is in right field defensively, and the new pitcher, lefty Mike Stanton.
23rd appearance of the year for Stanton. The record stands at 2-0. He's worked 22 and a third innings, allowing 20 hits and 7 earned runs, 7 walks, 15 strikeouts. Opponents hitting .247 off Mike Stanton. Well, this one has turned around a little bit.
Certainly has. The Yankees, after the Red Sox tonight, had leads of 6-0, 7-1, 8-2. Now back within a run as they score five times in the seventh. And it's an 8-7 Red Sox lead. Yankees out hitting Boston 14-12. Veritek has a hit tonight. He's 1-for-3. One to Veritek. He'll be followed by Baerga and Ray Sanchez scheduled in the inning. The 45th game of the year for the Red Sox, 31-13, and a two-game lead over the Yankees. And a win tonight would secure the fact that the Red Sox would be in first place when the Yankees leave on Sunday night. Red Sox getting to Roger Clemens tonight for 7 runs, 5 earned. Roger only hanging around for 3 2/3. $34,175 on hand tonight, the 15th sellout of the year for the Red Sox. the ground and outside a third foul. 1-2 to Jason Veritek. Stanton spent a considerable amount of time in Atlanta to begin his career. He was there 89 through 95. Coming to Boston in 95 and was here in 95 and 96. Texas for half a year and has been in New York since 1997. Foul tipped into the catcher's mitt. Veritek strikes out to open up the bottom of the seventh inning.
Mike Stanton's done a terrific job in this role as setup man for Mariano Rivera over the last couple of seasons for the Yankees. Fastball that time by Veritek for the strikeout.
He's played for some very good teams between the Braves, the Rangers, and the Yankees. He's got a pretty good string of postseason.
He's got a lot of playoff money. A lot of playoff money.
Like something like 8 or 9 of the last years consecutively is in there for the strike two by Erga. The Red Sox traded him on July 31st of 95 for a couple of players to be named later. Mark Brandenburg and Kerry Lacy turned out to be those pitchers. Lacy spending the bulk of his career in Pawtucket, and Mark Brandenburg, the sidewinder, saw some time here in Boston. They were both right-handed pitchers. Carlos Baerga, 1-for-3. In the air to right center field. Bernie Williams on the run. Back towards the triangle. He'll make the catch. Bit of a snow cone for a moment as he ran onto the dirt of the track in right center. Well, he hauls it in. Baerga gives it a ride, but he's out number two.
And the wind pushing out toward that Red Sox bullpen, but Bernie has plenty of room to make the play. Wow. Almost bounced out. Had to open the glove up again to get it back in the pocket. Wakefield continues to throw in the Red Sox bullpen, so he'll probably come on in the eighth.
Ray Sanchez doubled and scored in the fourth, 1-for-3 tonight. His two flyouts besides his double. And so Mike Stanton has pitched in 6 World Series and 7 league championships. Held off the right side. And with Texas, he also appeared in a division series postseason. So he's been all about the postseason. In his career, he's landed on some very good teams and he's been a very good pitcher throughout his career.
That's the kind of guy, even after he retires, you might want to try to sign him anyway, because just having him hang around, he might go to the postseason.
And he's a lefty. Outside, 2-1.
Can we talk you out of retirement? Not to pitch, just come sit with the team, travel. And
maybe give us some good karma. Career World Series games pitched. 20. Two behind Whitey Ford in that category. Softly lined and snared by Giambi. It is the first.
Well, back at Fenway, it's a one-run game as we go to the top of the eighth inning. The Red Sox lead it by 1. You'll get extra interviews, extra highlights, and extra analysis on Extra Innings, Nesson's expanded postgame show brought to you by Keyspan, putting more energy into life. And tonight, featuring postgame guest Pedro Martinez. After the last inning, the action is just beginning.
Well, we got plenty of action here as we prepare for the top of the eighth. The Red Sox will use their fourth pitcher of the night, Tim Wakefield.
12th appearance for Wakefield, 2nd of this series. He worked an inning last night, had a strikeout, leaving it up to Urbina to close it out. 31 strikeouts and 35 2/3 for Tim with only 11 walks.
And a couple of tough customers to face right out of the gate. Jeter, Williams, and Giambi scheduled in the visiting half of the eighth for the Yankees. Derek Jeter has 2 hits tonight, both singles to center. After singling to center last inning, he scored the 4th Yankees run, a 370 hitter against Wakefield. Right after that pitch, 1-1.
370 with three home runs against Wakefield. 10 for 27.
Chase, 2-1. So the Red Sox have used John Burkett, went 6-plus, giving up 4 runs. Fossum, 2/3, 2 runs. Garces, 1/3 a run. Good cut from Jeter, 2-2. Field making his 12th appearance, certainly seems like a lot more than that. A 2-2. Got him. Veritek will apply the tag just for safekeeping. One down.
All knuckleballs from Wakefield to Derek Jeter. Almost no rotation on that pitch at all. Veritek drops it but applies the tag for the first out. Bernie's going to swing around and bat right-handed against Wakefield. 269 career average with a home run.
Why do guys do this? We see this quite a bit.
Now, the ball's not going to break away from him, for one thing. So that's one thing they don't have to worry about. Most of the time, it's going to break down and in. And in this case, at Fenway, being a right-handed hitter, why not? You've got the short left-field wall out there.
A lot of guys who are switch hitters bat from the right side against the knuckleballer. Williams has 3 hits tonight. Or sometimes you see on some of the soft throwers, or the guy with the break ball like Jamie Moyer last year,
yeah, Everett,
like that.
Everett used to stay on the left side to hit against him.
One and one to Bernie Williams. One out, top of the 8th. 8-7, Red Sox on top.
We've seen guys, Don, and I think Bernie might be one of them where one time he'll hit right-handed against him. If that didn't work, he'll swing around on the left side.
Well, Williams is a switch hitter. If we get to Posada, he is a switch hitter. Rig out. And it's now 3-1 to Bernie Williams. More action in the Boston pen. It's like Urbina up.
Up early, huh?
Certainly is with one out here in the 8th. No action. The Yankees pen. Mike Stanton on 12 pitches took care of the Red Sox. 1-2-3 in the bottom of the 7th inning. The first time all night the Red Sox have gone 1-2-3. This darts in for a strike and a full count to Bernie Williams.
Wakefield not giving in with the fastball. 3-1 goes to the curveball for a strike.
Wakefield with the payoff pitch. Chopped down the third baseline foul.
Another curveball. Back-to-back curveballs. 3-1, then again on 3-2.
Wakefield goes with it again. The payoff pitch. Down and away, and he walks in. So Wakefield giving up his first walk of his outing, the 4th walk tonight for Red Sox pitching. Let's check in with Tom Karen. Tom.
Thank you, Don. We are here with our Not Your Typical fans from Citizens Bank. Jim and Kim Markey have not had a typical game. Kim, what happened tonight?
Well, I didn't expect anything different than going to a baseball game, and Jim told me to look up at the screen, and he proposed.
Jim, how long have you been planning this?
Couple of months I've been planning it, and last 2 days have been pretty long, but pulled off. I want to tell all my kids it worked. Thank you for your help. And I want to say the pub, Red Sox country's here. We did it.
You've got some 100 people watching at the pub tonight. They say it's been a love fest at Fenway. Well, it has been in Section 11 tonight. Guys.
All right, TC. Way to go, Jim. One out as Giambi takes a pitch.
Well, from all of us here at Nesson, we certainly wish you the best of luck.
Way to go, Jim. J. Jason Giambi homered to right center field in the fourth, 1-for-3 with a walk as he takes a strike, got the hands out of the way and got the bad news. A strike, 1-1. Up and in. You hit him? No. Glance back, and Veritek runs it down. Up to second base goes Williams. Need to glance off something. Must have been Veritek.
Yeah, I think off the glove. This knuckleball just really took off, and Veritek had no chance to catch this. Watch at the end of this how it just takes off, up and away, hits the heel of the glove, and deflects away. So the tying run now in scoring position for the Yankees.
And from the Yankees' perspective, they got the right guy at the plate in Giambi. A 2-1 up and away, 3-1. First base is vacant. Posada would be next as he waits on deck. A switch hitting catcher for the Yankees. 3-1, all four. And Giambi makes his way down to first base after Wakefield struck out Derek Jeter to begin this, the top of the eighth. He walks Bernie Williams and Jason Giambi back to back.
Red Sox this year have 8 pass balls as a team, and 5 of them are with Wakefield pitching.
Well, Posada was on the wrong end of a major league leading 18 pass balls last year, but he's got the bat in his hand this time as he bats in the top of the eighth. 0-for-4 tonight. Strike 1 to Posada. Bernie Williams at second. Jason Giambi at first. One out. Despite having leads of 6-0, 7-1, 8-2, the Red Sox trying to preserve their one-run advantage here in the eighth.
Looks like we're going to have a pinch runner, I believe. Time was called by the third base umpire for that Yankee dugout. Looks like Enrique Wilson is going to come out and run for Giambi. So Enrique Wilson, who would be the potential go-ahead run, a little more speed at first base in case there's a ball hitting the gap.
For the Yankees. Now running for Giambi at first base, number 14, Enrique Wilson.
That takes Giambi out of the game.
Now running for Giambi.
That may prove to be costly at some point, but he is gone. Wilson is at first. Williams at second. One down. This is away to Posada. 1-1. Robin Ventura would be next. He's on deck. Now the 1-1. Swung on and missed. Gets through Veritek. A late break. Heading to third is Williams, and he'll get there. Up to second base goes Enrique Wilson. Veritek wasn't even sure it was by him. And both runners able to advance once they all located the baseball.
Bernie wasn't sure either. Sometimes when you're at second base, it's hard to see just how far that ball gets by the catcher. You screen by the catcher, sometimes the umpire. Right there, see it right underneath the glove. Veritek thought he had it at first, but didn't. Now Bernie not sure either. He goes back to the bag, but Enrique Wilson was taken off of second base.
The second pass ball of the inning. This time puts the tying run potentially and the go-ahead run potentially in the scoring position. Still only one out.
Red Sox infield at halfway at second and short.
The 2-2 to Posada. Foul tipped. He stays alive. Posada 0-for-4 tonight. A strikeout in the second. Couple of ground outs. And a flyout tonight for Posada. The 2-2. Fouled off the left side. Up off the 600 club and back down again. Still 2-2. Burkett, Fossum, Garces, and now Wakefield used in tonight's game. Williams at third, Wilson at second base. The 2-2, Posada slices it foul back to the backstop.
Well, you've already seen a couple of pass balls this inning. Certainly more pressure on Veritek now with that man at third base.
Urbina looking on. He's not throwing anymore in the bullpen, but should they need him, he's plenty ready. The 2-2. Again, Posada gets a piece. And the lengthy at bat continues.
Yeah, these are all pretty good knuckleballs, too, that he's fouling off.
Sox infield playing it halfway defensively with one out in the eighth. 2-2. Posada chops it foul into the Boston dugout down at the far end.
Only pitch that Wakefield's not tried against Posada, the fastball. That was a curveball that he fouled off.
This will be the ninth pitch of the at-bat. In the air to left field. Back goes Daubach. Williams will be tagging up. Daubach makes the catch. The throw will go to third, and the Yankees have come all the way back to tie it at eight. Leads of 6-0, 7-1, 8-2 by the boards as the Yankees, with a run on the top of the eighth, have tied the contest at eight.
Yankees all on a top step out of the dugout to congratulate Posada. That was a pretty good at bat. He fouled off some nasty knuckleballs from Wakefield. Finally got one he could lift in the air to the opposite field to score the tying run.
And unfortunately for John Burkett, no decision. They will intentionally walk Robin Ventura with first base open. And when it's all said and done, the Yankees will have runners at first and second, two outs. Looking ahead to the bottom of the eighth, the Red Sox have the top of their order. Johnny Damon, Jose Offerman, and Nomar Garciaparra expected. And the Yankees still have no one up in the bullpen, so it will likely be the lefty Mike Stanton again. So the Red Sox, who got to Roger Clemens for about as much as you can get to Roger, over 3 2/3, 7 runs. Now in the midst of a tie in the eighth. Third walk of the inning given up by Wakefield. Of course, this one of the intentional variety. And it brings up Shane Spencer, who walked pinch hitting an inning ago. Which of the inning in which the Yankees made the most hay in terms of the comeback. They sent 10 men to the plate and scored 5 times in the seventh.
Yeah, Soriano got it all started with a home run to lead off the seventh inning.
On the ground towards Nomar. Garciaparra goes to second, and that'll do it. The force out of Ventura goes 6-4. The Yankees have gotten the run and have tied this one 8-8 as we head to the bottom of the eighth. Back at Fenway Park in the midst of an 8-8 ball game. The Red Sox on top in this game a few times, 6-0, 7-1, 8-2. Omar Garciaparra going deep for the sixth time in the sixth inning. He's got 4 RBIs in the ball game tonight. It is now an 8-8 ball game. Garciaparra 3-for-3, a home run and 4 runs batted in. Nixon 1-for-4 with a double, a couple of RBIs. Soriano has a home run for the Yankees, 1-of-2. Giambi with the other. Burkett's fine effort of 6 innings, 11 hits, 4 runs, a walk, 7 Ks. Results in a no decision. Roger Clemens chased from the game after 3 2/3 off the hook. Thanks to the Yankee comeback, 5 in the 7th, 1 in the 8th, tied 8-8. Enrique Wilson, who pinch ran last inning, moves into third base. And going from third to first is Robin Ventura. Giambi was run for, and that could be somewhat of a situation as the game goes on, tied 8-8. He's out of the game as Johnny Damon leads off here in the bottom of the eighth. We'll just be a spectator for the rest of this one. Damon, Offerman, and Garciaparra, the top of the Red Sox order to face Mike Stanton who made quick work of the Red Sox in the eighth, sending them down, or in the seventh rather, sending them down 1-2-3. Damon walked his first two plate appearances tonight and scored both times. Since then has grounded out twice. Also has a stolen base tonight. Inside, 2-1. What a classic Red Sox-Yankees battle here tonight. 14 hits for the Yankees, 12 hits for the Red Sox. The 2-1. Raymond wraps it towards right center field. On the run is Spencer. He's not going to get there. Off the base of the bullpen wall. Into second base with a wall ball. Leadoff double goes Johnny Damon.
Johnny Damon does a great job hitting against left hand as he stays in there. He gets the fastball on time from standing right at the base of the bullpen wall. So now Jose Offerman's job is to move him along the third base either by the bunt or moving the ball to the right side. I would pretty much expect the bunt at this stage of the ball game.
And if he does his bunting, he'll be doing it from the right side against the left-handers. Offerman turns around and bats from the right side. Started from the left side against the Yankee starter tonight, Roger Clemens.
Red Sox have sacrificed the fewest times in the league. But this is begging for one.
Screaming for one. Zan glances at second. Offerman is not bunting, and that one almost got away from Posada. Now does. Ended up flipped up over his head and behind him, and Offerman was not squaring.
Boxed around a little bit here by Posada as it popped right out of his glove and rolled down his back.
Offerman 0 for 4 tonight. During his fifth at bat as he bats in the eighth. Going inside, and again, not showing any signs of laying down a bunt. 2-0.
I think the Yankee infield stunned that he has not squared around yet. If he hasn't bunted and done the first two pitches, I doubt he will be on the 2-0 count.
Brady has said it before, it is not like giving up outs, but this situation will anticipate a bunt. The 2-0 pitch. Early swinging, he fouls it back to the backstop, 2-1.
Now that wasn't a swing designed to go to the other field, too, the opposite way. That was a swing designed to put two quick runs on the board. 2-0 fastball. Offerman trying to pull that ball, fouls it off.
Offerman bats now. Garcia Parra on deck. 8-8 ball game. The Red Sox have the go-ahead run in scoring position with nobody out. And a golden opportunity here in the bottom of the eighth. Stanton's 2-1. Offerman now showing bunt. Did he offer at it? No. And it's 3-1.
Well, if he didn't bunt 2-0, will he be bunting 3-1? I doubt it.
Looks down in the direction of Mike Cubbage, who reels off the sides for both him and Damon at second base. Doesn't square, swings, and lifts it down the right field line. In comes Spencer, falling and falling harmlessly foul. Jumps up into the seats. Now the count will be full to Jose Offerman.
Looks like a sign fell down down that right field line. That's the delay now. Where the ball bounced up into the stand, something fell.
Is it a Remy sign?
Oh, I see they're covering up a sign. Oh, they mustn't have paid the bill.
Don't pay the bill, you don't get the sign.
And they're all taking congratulations from that lovely fan in the front row.
Offerman has had to wait. The count remains the same. 3-2. Damon at second base representing the go-ahead run. Bottom of the eighth. The payoff pitch. Up and away. Ball four, Watson. So Offerman will make his way down the line to first.
And Joe Torre out of the dugout. Steve Passe has been loosening in the bullpen.
Stanton sending down the Red Sox in order in the first inning of relief for the left-hander. But here in the bottom of the eighth inning, a double and now a walk to Offerman, and that's it for Stanton. So he has headed off, and the Yankees will use their fourth pitcher of the night. Yankees and Red Sox tied at 8 from Fenway in the bottom of the eighth.
Mike Stanton out of the ball game with this game tied at 8. The 2002 Red Sox media guide is now available. You'll find over 500 pages filled with facts and stats on the current team records and historical data, complete information on the Red Sox minor league system, and much more. To receive your copy, send a check or money order for $16 to Red Sox media guide, 4 Yawkey Way, Boston, Mass. 02215.
The fourth Yankees pitcher of the night is right-hander Steve Carce.
Had a great year for the Yankees, 24th appearance, the 1-1 record. Look at 1.98 ERA, only 19 hits allowed in 27 a third, 26 strikeouts, and opponents hitting 192 off Carce. Well, if Jose wasn't bunting, you can bet Nomar's not.
Yeah. Well, Nomar will be batting. When we are set, Johnny Damon at second, Offerman at first. 8-8 ball game. Red Sox and Yankees, 2002 style here tonight. And the Red Sox fans, who had a lot to cheer about early, as the Red Sox got to Roger Clemens over 3 2/3 for 7 runs. And the Yankees have clawed back, tied at 8-8. And an opportunity for the Red Sox in the bottom of the eighth to push one ahead here. Career against Carce for Garcia Parra, 333. Nomar homered his last time up. His sixth home run of the year. He's got a 4 RBI night with 3 hits to go along with his home run. And Omar fouls the first one off the fist.
Don, we've been on this homestand now almost 2 weeks. That's a lot of at-bats for Omar. I can't remember 5 times where he hadn't swung at the first pitch.
It's one of those things that you can almost take for granted.
Yeah.
But still, pitchers continue to throw him strikes. 0-1 the count. Say looking at second base, a few ganders. Nomar lines it, snared at third. Enrique Wilson makes the catch, and there's the first out in the bottom of the eighth.
Well, Red Sox lucky that didn't turn into a double play. A rocket by Garcia Parra, but right at Enrique Wilson, had nowhere to go. He looked toward first base. There was no chance there. He couldn't go to second because the runner was in his way.
The left fielder, Brian Nomar.
Now Brian Daubach, the left-hander against the right-hander here. Bryant singled in the first, struck out in the second, doubled in the fourth, lined out to left in the sixth. 2 of 13 Boston hits belong to Brian Daubach. Runners on, the responsibility of the departed left-hander, Mike Stanton.
I say last year with both Cleveland and Atlanta, 74 appearances on the season, signed a 4-year deal with an option year. It's a long-term contract for a setup guy.
He is. Not a long-time contract for anybody. The 1-0, low and inside, 2-0. It's like a Remy deal right there.
Yeah, one day at a time.
Jay Hillenbrand waits on deck. Damon at second. Offerman at first, one down. Arce wants to see the signs again, and Posada hops up. Falling behind Daubach, 2-0. Yankees have used Clemens, Hitchcock, Stanton, and now Carce. The 2-0 from Carce to Daubach. Sliced foul off the left side. 2-1. Johnny Damon doubled off the base of the bullpen wall and right to begin the inning. Offerman walked. Carce comes on to get Garcia Parr to line up. 2-1, one away. Carce taking a long time in between pitches, and Daubach requests time. Now the right-hander ready from the stretch. The 2-1, 3-1 to Daubach. Ruggier Bina up in the bullpen. Say again, wants to see the signs again. Trying to ice Daubach here. It's taking a long time in between deliveries. Now he's ready. The 3-1 to Daubach. Ball four. Oh no, he called it the strike. Late strike call from Paul Schreiber, and it's a full count.
Daubach tried to draw ball four as he took a step toward first base. Close pitch.
He had me drawn. Full count. Damon at second, Offerman at first. And the payoff pitch from Carce. Daubach sends it foul off the left side. Still a full count. That was at 93 miles per hour from the right-hander.
Willie Randolph, Mel Stottlemyre, Joe Torre. One of the few times you see Joe standing up.
There is Zimmer. He's normally right by him. One out here in the last of the eighth inning. The 3-2 again to Brian Daubach. This time it is ball four. Brian looks back just to make sure, and it loads the bases. The second walk of the inning given up by the Yankees. And it'll give Hillenbrand a chance to bat. His first grand slam of his career has come this season, the catwalk shot in Tampa Bay. Well, the pinch runner for Daubach, Ricky Henderson, will pinch run for Daubach.
Well, the only reason I can see for that with a tie ball game is maybe Ricky can get down to second base quicker to try to break up a double play. Yankee middle infielder is playing back for the double play.
Hillenbrand at 333 in his short major league career with the bases loaded. Has three hits tonight and has been intentionally walked. He's also driven in a run. Carce made Daubach wait a long time in between pitches, and Hillenbrand still waiting. And now Posada jumps out and he'll head to the mound. It's been an eternity in between pitches for Carce. Now Mel Stottlemyer will join the conversation. Posada doesn't know he's out there. He'll have to go back. He was headed in behind the dish again. The Yankees have no further action in the pen. Steve Carce right now, the man of the hour for the Yankees. So a leadoff double for Johnny Damon to begin this, the bottom of the eighth. A walk to Offerman spelled the end for Mike Stanton tonight, the lefty reliever left. Carce came on, got Nomar to line out to third base, Enrique Wilson. And then the walk to Brian Daubach. The question is, Mariano Rivera healthy enough to go? Some question about his health and his availability in this series. The jacket on out there in the Yankees bullpen right now. Damon at third, Offerman at second. Ricky Henderson pinch running for Daubach at first. Strike one to Shea Hillenbrand. Ten RBIs from the seventh inning on leads the Red Sox in that category. Shea has done some of his best work in the later stages of some games this year for the Red Sox. The 0-1 from Carce. Hillenbrand fights it off on the ground to first. Coming home for the lead out there is Robin Ventura, and they throw out Johnny Damon for the inning, second out.
Now Ventura, who has plenty of experience over there at first base, I believe 75 big league games at that position, did not panic, did not rush, knew he could only get one out, and made sure he made a good throw to Posada at home plate.
They force out Johnny Damon. Now Trot Nixon bats. Offerman at third, Henderson at second, Hillenbrand at first. Nixon doubled in the third, one for four tonight. He's got three grand slams in his career. Strike one over the outside corner. And the Red Sox with a runner in scoring position with nobody out to begin the inning. Now there are two outs. Go-ahead run just 90 feet away. Nixon in the hole, nothing in two.
Back-to-back changeups by Carce.
Carce, the fourth pitcher used tonight by the Yankees. Ahead of Nixon, nothing in two, and again wants to see the signs again. 8-8 in the bottom of the eighth. And again he backs off.
Posada and Carce having a tough time getting on the same page. Two different sets of signs thrown out by Posada. Carce didn't like either one of them.
We've gone back and forth during the entire inning. The 0-2 on the ground. It is handled by Ventura. He'll take it alone and the Yankees somehow get out of the inning. The Red Sox will leave them loaded in the bottom of the eighth, on to the ninth, still tied at eight. Back at Fenway, still tied at eight as we get ready for the ninth inning. Ricky Henderson pinch running last inning for Brian Daubach, takes over for Daubach in left field. And the Red Sox will use their fifth pitcher of the night, Burkett Urbina.
At times you're playing at home in a tie ball game, the closer will come in. In the top of the ninth inning, try to shut him down and give you a chance to score in the bottom of the ninth to win the game. Ugi picked up the save last night. Three strikeouts in the ninth inning to pick up the save.
We'll be dealing with Rondell White, Nick Johnson, and Alfonso Soriano, the expected hitters here as we move to the top of the ninth. Keeping in mind that the bottom of the ninth for the Red Sox will represent the bottom third of their order. Veritek, Bayergan, Sanchez expected. Rondell White, three hits tonight, two runs driven in. He's three for four.
Yeah.
First one in there for a strike at 96 miles per hour. The velocity has really returned for Burkett Urbina as of late. Really letting it rip. This is away, 1-1. No action in either bullpen as we move here to the top of the ninth inning. The Red Sox are on their fifth pitcher. The Yankees have used four in this one. Chopped outside of third and foul 1-2 now to Rondell White. Tim Wakefield was charged with one run in one inning of work. He worked the eighth. Red Sox have used Burkett, Fossum, Garces, Wakefield, and now Urbina. The run that Wakefield gave up was unearned. One, two to Rondell White. A little check swing number over by the Fungo Circle on the first base side. Still 1-2.
Rondell White had a big hit back in that seventh inning. The base hit to drive in a couple. Johnson then followed with a base hit to drive in a run. Five runs in the seventh.
That was really the inning in which the Yankees started their comeback. Red Sox had an 8-2 lead. They scored five times in the seventh. Added a run to tie it up in the eighth. Here we are, 8-8 in the top of the ninth. Opposite field, and that will fall. Foul. Started fair, kept bending away. Unfortunately for the Red Sox, a foul ball. Still 1-2.
Right off the end of the bat for Rondell White. That ball looked to be maybe a couple of inches off the outside edge. He makes contact, but just in foul territory. First base umpire Reynolds getting a good look at it.
It is a quiet Fenway right now, 34,175. Boisterous early in this game as the Red Sox got to Clemens for seven runs over 3 2/3. The 1-2. Broken back grounder at Garcia Parra. Omar throws out Rondell White, one down.
I don't think anybody's left this park either.
No. Look at the capacity, 34,175.
Only people that have left are those who have been asked to by law enforcement.
Yeah.
That's it.
There's been a few of them. Here is Nick Johnson, the number nine hitter, 1-for-4 with a run driven in. He's singled and moving a run in the seventh inning. He's 1-for-1 with a home run against Ugi Urbina. Mile-per-hour strike. Dealing with 15 saves on here in a non-save situation. A tie ball game in the ninth. The 0-1 to Johnson. Fouled straight back to the backstop. Urbina's ahead, nothing in two. The top of the order and the very dangerous Alfonso Soriano waits on deck. Three hits tonight, including his 12th home run of the year for the Yankees leadoff hitter. The 0-2. Inside almost hit him. 97 miles per hour that time from Urbina. Johnson got out of the way. 1-2.
Johnson's accustomed to getting hit by pitches seven times already this season. That one was almost eight. Your buddy David Eckstein is the leader in that category with nine.
Always finds a way on. One and two the count to Nick Johnson. Urbina ready and the pitch. just missing. Framed by Veritek. Thought he had the outside corner, but instead it's ball two, 2-2.
Boogie was so sure he dropped to one knee. Maybe a little bit low. Close. Been a couple of those here in the last few innings.
The Yankees are now out hitting the Red Sox 14-13. Looking away, and it's a full count now. Boogie at 97, but not controlling it right now. Red Sox outfield straight away. The wind not nearly what it was early. It was really gusting around. We had three separate isolated showers that kind of came and went. Nothing that stopped the game. Urbina with the payoff pitch. Sliced foul off the left side. Still a full count. Yankees have two home runs in the game to add on to their league-leading total. And on deck, Soriano hit his 12th, and Jason Giambi hit his 11th tonight, and he is out of the game. He was pinch run for by Enrique Wilson in the 8th, so he will not be helping the Yankees the rest of the way here in an 8-8 ball game in the 9th. The payoff pitch again. In the air, foul off third. Hillenbrand heading over towards the Yankees dugout. It's coming back, and he'll make the catch. Backspin on that one keeps it in the yard, and Hillenbrand takes care of it for the inning second out.
Number 12, the second baseman, Alfonso Soriano.
You know, another tough out. Not that there's many easy ones inside this Yankees order. Soriano has three hits tonight, a home run and a run driven in. Hitting at 323 on the year. Got away as it misses ball one. Again, looking ahead to the bottom of the ninth. Jason Veritek, Carlos Baerga, and Ray Sanchez are the expected hitters. Urbina working from the stretch with no one on. 1-0, swung on and missed, 1-1.
Slide at that time by Urbina. Apparently he liked that because he was shaking his head up and down. Yes. On the way back to the mound.
Not hide the emotion, Zugi Urbina. A lot of fun to watch. Ready to go now at the 1-1 to Soriano. Shortened up and takes the strike. 1-2. One strike away from getting out of the top of the ninth and sending this one to the bottom of the ninth. The 1-2 from Oogie. They got him. First strikeout for Urbina closes out the top of the ninth. The Yankees go 1-2-3 on to the bottom of the ninth. Tied at 8.
Urbina puts the Yankees down 1-2-3 in the top of the ninth to keep the score tied. Well, Nesson is your ticket to Pawtucket Red Sox action from McCoy Stadium. It's minor league baseball, major league action, as the Stars of tomorrow play today with the Paw Sox. Thursday, May 30th, the Paw Sox take on the Columbus Clippers, and Nesson is your ticket to all the action. Coverage begins at 7 only on Nesson.
Steve Carce back out there for the bottom of the ninth. You got the final two outs in the 8th. Actually got all the outs in the 8th. As Johnny Damon was gunned down at the plate. First battery face, Nomar lined out, and then he got Nixon to ground out to end the inning, and the Red Sox left the bases loaded. Jason Veritek, 1-for-4 tonight, gets her started in the bottom of the ninth. Strike one over the outside corner. Veritek will be followed by Carlos Baerga, who is standing on deck, and then Ray Sanchez as the Red Sox send the bottom third of their order to the plate in the bottom of the ninth.
If the Red Sox do not score here in the ninth, it looks like Arojo may be coming in. He's loosening up. I wouldn't think they'd want Urbina any more than one inning. Good changeup.
Nasty. 1-2 now to Veritek.
Some very good changeups to lefties. A couple of Nixon last inning. And that one to Veritek.
Eight into the bottom of the ninth. Yeah, Veritek gets a piece to stay alive. Roger Clemens started tonight for the Yankees, lasted 3 2/3. The Red Sox scored 7 times on him. 5 of the 7 runs earned runs. We've seen Sterling Hitchcock, Mike Stanton, and now Steve Carce. Veritek strikes out looking. One down in the bottom of the ninth.
Now they threw him back-to-back changeups and then bust him inside with the fastball. Good pitch.
First strikeout for Steve Carce and Carlos Baerga. 1-for-4 tonight. Carlos getting the start as the designated hitter, batting 8th. And his hit came back in the second inning. Cut from Carlos. Last time up, he really gave it a ride out onto the warning track in right center field, back by the triangle, but Bernie Williams ran it down. Erga does not have a home run in a Red Sox uniform as of yet. Down 0-2. Has done a pretty good job since coming on here. Right hander ready again. Chop down the first baseline. Ventura will flip to the pitcher covering, and some nifty footwork turned in by Steve Carce as they get Baerga 2 down.
Well, that's not an easy play there of Ventura giving that little flip to Carce so close to him. I can't believe it. Carce was able to see the ball.
13, the second baseman.
Ventura here charges in. He's playing the line. Now watch this flip. It's amazing Carce is able to handle that.
Well, Ventura, who has seen the bulk of his major league career at third base, you mentioned the 75 games at first, certainly played very well over here at first base, and the chances that he has had, including a throw out at the plate in the eighth and a couple of ground outs. Ray Sanchez takes strike one. 1-for-4 tonight is Ray. He doubled back in the fourth inning. This is away. We'll get Urbina sent down the Yankees 1-2-3 in the ninth. Carce trying to send the Red Sox down 1-2-3 in the bottom of the ninth. Urbina with the jacket on. The 1-1. Sanchez fouls it off the right side, and it's 1-2. Battle tonight between the Red Sox and Yankees, tied at 8 in the bottom of the ninth. 2 down. A 1-2 pitch to Sanchez. He has a piece of it, fouling it off. Still 1-2.
Now, what you expected to be a pitcher's night here at Fenway with Roger Stein in the game, and of course the way Burkett's going. Red Sox control the first half of the game, the Yankees the second half of the game, and now it's in the hands of the bullpen, deep into the bullpen.
The top of the order for the Red Sox, Johnny Damon's on deck, two outs. And it evens up at 2-2. Johnny had doubled to begin things in the bottom of the eighth, but was thrown out at the plate, forced out at the plate in the eighth inning. The Red Sox did not score, left the bases loaded. Red Sox have left 10 men on through the first eight innings. And a full count now to Sanchez. Also was ahead, but a full count now to the Red Sox second baseman. Chop towards Soriano at second base. Sets and throws, and the Red Sox are gone in the ninth. So we're headed for extra frames tonight from Fenway, tied at 8. Back at Fenway, tied 8-8 in the top of the 10th inning. There are athletes, there are superstars, and there are legends of the game. Relive the careers of Carlton Fisk and Cam Neely, two athletes who changed the way their games were played. Legends of the Game, a one-hour front row special premiering Sunday night, June 2nd on NESN. On to the 10th inning. The Red Sox will employ their sixth pitcher of the night, Orlando Arojo, into the game.
14th appearance of the season for Arojo. His record stands at 2-1. His last outing on the 21st against the White Sox. Two innings in that game, four hits, a couple of earned runs, and one strikeout for Orlando. 12 walks, 11 strikeouts.
And he'll face a tough part of the order, Derek Jeter, Bernie Williams, and instead of Jason Giambi, because Enrique Wilson ran for him in the eighth, it'll be Enrique Wilson third. So Rojo ready to work here. Jeter, 2-for-5 tonight. That's out of the way as he squared the bunt.
Just went over to check on Mariano Rivera's availability from the Yankee guys, and they said, yeah, he had a groin problem, but he threw yesterday, and if they got the lead, he'd be in the game tonight.
Jeter against Arojo, 4-for-17, 5 walks at .235. This is the first extra innings game of the year for the Red Sox, the very first. The Yankees, this is their third, and they come into this extra inning affair with a record of 1-1. Both teams with 31 wins, but the Red Sox with a two-game advantage heading into tonight's action. Rojo dropping down, grooving in the strike, 1-2. Rojo on for Uguet Urbina, who worked the ninth, the 1-2-3 ninth, including a strikeout. Just misses to Jeter, 2-2. They have the right people coming up in the bottom of the 10th inning for the Red Sox. Johnny Damon would lead it off. Jose Offerman and then Nomar Garciaparra expected. Going away in a full count. Pitch sent down the right field line. It is a foul ball. Jumps up down that right field line as Jeter tried to go the opposite way, and it'll be a full count again when he gets back in the box. Derek Jeter had two hits in the first game of the series, going 2-for-4 last night. He's got two more tonight. Came into tonight's action at 3-12 on the year. On the ground, Hillenbrand, who is left, sets and throws out number one in the 10th. One down, and it brings up Bernie Williams, who will bat now from the left side.
Number 51.
The right-hander Rojo working in the 10th. Two hits against Rojo. One of those, a home run for Bernie Williams. Bernie Williams with 215 career home runs, ranking 8th in the Yankees' all-time list. He is in reach of Don Mattingly, who had 222, 7 home runs shy of Mattingly's output. And he bats with one out here in the 10th. In there for the strike. 1-1 now to Bernie Williams. Enrique Wilson waits on deck for the Yankees. He came on to pinch run for Jason Giambi in the 8th. Just missed again. Held on to for an extra second by Veritek. Things are quiet right now as Rojo brings the 2-1. That's in there for the strike, 2-2.
Only guy left in that bullpen for the Red Sox would be Sonny Kim.
Well, you would anticipate that Rolando will go here a while. Should he need to, into extra innings. On the ground, Garcia Parra has it and throws out. Bernie Williams, two down in the 10th. So two ground ball outs induced by Rolando Arojo of Jeter and Williams, and those are two big outs here in the 10th.
Number 14, the third baseman, Enrique Wilson.
Now Enrique Wilson batting for the first time. He came on to pinch run in the 8th. He's a 375 hitter against Rolando Arojo. He had not played in the last 6 games since the pinch running earlier. Any pinch runs here tonight. Swings away and fouls it. Ends up all the way out at second base to Ray Sanchez, but a foul ball, and Wilson went down in a heap.
Right off the knee, it looked like. I don't think he was faking that.
No, I got the impression that was real.
That'd be pretty good acting.
Well, it happened earlier to Alfonso Soriano. Enrique Wilson was acquired by the Yankees from Pittsburgh in exchange for lefty Dimaso Marte. Last year played 48 games for the Yankees at 242 at one home run, 12 runs batted in.
Didn't you just see Dimaso Marte?
Yeah, with the
Chicago?
White Sox, right? Yeah. So he's moved around since the trade. The 1-1 to Wilson. Inside and low. 2-1. And John Burkett appeared to be sailing along to his 6th victory without a loss. When he left, it was 8-4 Boston, but now 8-8 in the top of the 10th inning. No decision tonight for John Burkett. In the air to the left. Pretty well. Back goes Ricky Henderson onto the track. Can't make the catch. Front of the wall. So back on the dirt of the track, but Ricky's there. The Yankees are down in order in the 10th. On to the bottom of the 10th. 8-8 from Fenway.
Well, the Red Sox with a chance to win it as we go to the bottom of the 10th here at Fenway. Sox fans, keep the Fenway experience going a little longer in 2002. The Diamond at Fenway behind Grandstand Section 30 will now serve as Fenway's own sports bar from the 7th inning until 2 hours after the game. So come enjoy the fun or watch the game maybe on one of the 14 TVs they have.
On to the bottom of the 10th inning. Yankees pitching has retired the last 5 Red Sox in a row. Steve Carce back out there for his third inning of relief. And he'll deal with the top of the Boston order. Johnny Damon doubled his last time up, 1-for-3 with a pair of walks tonight. He was at second base in the eighth in an 8-8 ball game with nobody out, but the Red Sox couldn't get him in. Strike one to Johnny Damon. After Damon, Offerman, Garcia Parra, and then if anybody gets on, Ricky Henderson would be scheduled as Ricky ran for Brian Dobbach in the eighth. Damon slaps it the opposite way, foul, and Johnny's down, nothing in two.
See, that was in the direction of that Diamond Club that you can go to after the game.
With the 14 TVs.
That's right.
The 0-2 to Damon. Chopped at. Didn't get down the line well. Soriano's got to hurry up, and he doesn't get it there in time. Damon beats it out. The infield hit. Red Sox have the lead man on in the bottom of the 10th.
Oh, it's nice to have speed. Johnny Damon with a kind of a routine bounce in the second. You knew it was going to be close because of the high bounce and the speed of Damon. Soriano does everything he can to get rid of it quickly, but Damon beats it out. Just reached out and tapped that ball. Stay away from the strikeout, get a base hit.
The 10th infield hit for Johnny Damon this season, leading the Red Sox in that category. Jose Offerman, 0-for-4 with a walk tonight. Throw over and Damon crosses over to return to the bag. Well, Offerman wasn't bunting last time. You would hope he would be as Damon gains his lead at first. Then on third is Enrique Wilson. Offerman swings away and lifts it in the air to right field. Pretty deep for Shane Spencer, shy of the track, and there's one away.
Now, if he bunts that time and is successful, he gets a man in the scoring position, you're definitely going to lose Garcia Parra. They're going to intentionally walk him, and then they'd work to Ricky Henderson.
So Offerman swinging away, flies to right, one down. And Garcia Parra will hit.
Now, this game gives you a pretty good idea what Grady Little thinks about the sacrifice bunt.
Not much. Garce off the backside, briefly in the midst of a meeting with himself as he toes the rubber. Now having to deal with Nomar Garcia Parra, one down, last of the 10th inning. 8-8 the score. Damon back.
Now you start thinking about the possibility of an attempted steal by Damon.
Ricky Henderson is on deck. He's not yet had an at-bat tonight. Nomar grounds it to third. Wilson to second for one, on to first. That will do the inning. So the leadoff man on, but a 5-4-3 around the horn twin killing sends us to the 11th, still tied at 8. Don Orsillo and Jerry Remy back at Fenway Park, ready for the 11th. The runs are identical, the hits are identical. The Yankees have committed the game's only error. The Red Sox in extra innings for the first time this season. Posada Ventura and Shane Spencer, the expected hitters to face Rolando Arojo. Sent down the Yankees 1-2-3 in the 10th. Posada 0-for-4 with a sacrifice fly tonight. The Yankees switch hitting catcher. That's from the left side against Arojo.
Not a good sign when you're still at the ballpark and the West Coast games are in about the third or fourth inning.
It'll be a short night for both teams with the day game here at Fenway Park tomorrow. A 1-0. It grabs the corner. Back door, 1-1. What was John Burkett and Roger Clemens at the beginning of tonight's game. And a lot has happened since then. And tonight, unfortunately for the Red Sox, they had a 6-0 lead, a 7-1 lead, an 8-2 lead, and unfortunately now tied at 8 into the 11th inning. Again over the outside corner. 2-2 now to Posada. In the full count. Wynn picks up again, the flag blowing from left to right across the outfield. Sliced foul off the left side, back and out of play. Oh, getting it up there, 93 miles per hour, that last pitch. Yankees right now have no action. Steve in their bullpen. Steve Carsey has gone the last three innings. There's Don Zimmer.
Zim looks a little grumpy.
Sliced foul off the left side, back and out of play.
Last run that was scored in this ball game, driven in by Posada on that sacrifice fly. Back in the eighth inning.
The Yankees with 14 hits in the game, and Posada does not have one. Enjoying his seventh season, looking on. Sliced foul off the left side. The rain delay in Kansas City with Texas on top 3-1.
Back to back nights, they had a rain delay there last night, too.
You see the West Coast game, some of them into the sixth inning. That one's in the fourth now. Minnesota blanking Anaheim. Oh, the payoff pitch to Posada again. In the air to left center field. Henderson moving over from his spot in left, and the Wynn played with it, but Ricky made the adjustment and makes the catch for the first out of the 11th.
And we watched it all night long, those pop-ups. Left field, third base, they've all been pushed back because of that breeze blowing out toward the bullpen area. Ricky at the last minute.
First baseman.
A couple of extra steps
Robin
to make that catch.
Ventura.
That flag is just pinned above us. And it's kind of been a swirling wind over the last couple of innings. Ricky makes the catch. Arojo's retired all four Yankees that he has faced so far. Robin Ventura, who has walked twice tonight, once intentionally, is 0 for 3 with two strikeouts. Burkett got him twice. 1 for 12 against Arojo is Ventura. Slapped on the ground, right side. Offerman will need Arojo. He's there. Two down. Now Shane Spencer, who pinch hit for John Vanderwall in the seventh inning and walked. He also scored. The Yankees' seventh run, grounded out in the eighth. So he's been in the game since the seventh inning, and he's 0 for 1 with a walk. Looking ahead to the bottom of the 11th inning. Henderson, Hillenbrand, and Nixon will be the hitters. And Steve Carsey's worked the last three innings of relief for the Yankees.
And he'll be out there again. Nobody loosening up in the bullpen.
They're pretty good, but they don't get the call. 1-1. Rojo's retired all five Yankees that he has faced. Rolled in, 1-2 now to Shane Spencer. Rojo gets the sign, goes to work. Here's the 1-2. Doesn't get him to chase, and it evens up at 2-2. Spencer missed the bulk of the 2000 season. Had surgery on his right knee, started last year on the DL. The 2-2. In the air to left field. Shallow. Out goes Nomar. In comes Ricky. Ricky calls off Nomar and puts it away. Another 1-2-3 inning for Rojo. We're on to the bottom of the 11th. Still tied at 8. Well, some crazy things have happened tonight. We're tied 8-8 into the bottom of the 11th inning. Orlando Rojo, two very good innings of relief, pitching the 10th and the 11th, retiring everybody that he's faced. And hoping his club can muster a run here in the bottom of the 11th inning. Ricky Henderson, Shea Hillenbrand, and Trot Nixon, the expected trio to face Steve Carce, ready to go with his fourth inning of relief out of the Yankees bullpen. Ricky Henderson came on to run for Daubach, who walked in the eighth, and Ricky batting for the first time tonight. 237, a home run, 9 runs batted in. Jose has only thrown 34 pitches through his three innings. So pitch counts in good shape out of the Yankees pen. Ricky goes the opposite way down the right field line. Spencer's on the run, and that will end up foul. He's got a long way to go, and he gets back into the seats. Spencer taking over for Vanderwall out in right field. Anderson, 1-for-4 with a run batted in here last night. He's had kind of a tough homestand, hitting at 192, 5-for-26. The 0-1, low and away, 1-1 now to Ricky. Now moves ahead of Cal Ripken with his appearance in tonight's game. For 7th place on the all-time list, and usual Eddie Murray. 5-for-6, he's got to play 24 more games to get to them. Going away now, 2-1 to Ricky. The milestones keep coming up for Ricky Henderson as the year goes on. I say with the 2-1. Anderson takes the strike, 2-2, and is miffed.
He's not going to like that one. It's a high strike. Ricky's not used to having that pitch called a strike. Working out of that crouch.
Guard the line. Wilson at third guarding the line. Oh, and it's a full count to Henderson. Deck for the Red Sox, Shea Hillenbrand. He's got 3 hits tonight. Red Sox trying to get the lead man on in the bottom of the 11th inning. Ricky chops at it. Going to be a tough play. Wilson charging hard, throwing on the run, and in head first is Ricky Henderson. And for the second straight inning, the Red Sox have the lead man on.
Ricky went into first base like he goes into second base on those steals. Head first and hard. Enrique Wilson charging hard, makes the throw, but not in time. Nice play by Ventura to knock that ball down. That was a one hop to Robin. Ball gets by him. Ricky's standing on second base.
How far did Enrique Wilson go? He's guarding the line.
Yeah.
Coming from behind the mound by the time he got rid of it. That's a third infield hit for Ricky Henderson. Johnny Damon leading the club with 10 infield hits.
Ricky with a couple of steals on the season has been caught one time.
Well, Shea Hillenbrand had a walk-off home run in the 18th inning last year against the Tigers. Chops it left side out of the reach of Wilson into left. Henderson will move up 90 feet to second. The Red Sox have the first 2 base runners on. A potential game-winning run in scoring position with nobody out in the bottom of the 11th inning.
Oh, what a big night for Hillenbrand. Four hits in the ballgame plus a walk, been on base five times. Curveball gets on top of it. Another high bounce that's going to get by Enrique Wilson. Remember earlier in the game he had one against Roger. That ball was up and away. A big high bounce over Giambi's head.
Nixon is 1-for-5 tonight. He doubled in the third inning. Couple of RBIs tonight for Nixon, now 17.
They're pulling Venturi in front of Hillenbrand just in case there's a bunt. But I wouldn't go to the bank on that.
Veritek waits on deck. Nixon. Real square. The predictability is gone. Strike one to Nixon. Joe Kerrigan was easier to follow in terms of managing along with.
Brady's got a bat there. Is he thinking about pinch hitting himself?
I don't know. 0-1 to Nixon. We'll see if he does it again. Anderson at second, representing the winning run here in the 11th. Anderson shows bunt again, drops it down, a fair ball. Looking at third, he better hurry up, gets it to first, they do get Nixon. Carson glanced at third, had no chance at Ricky. Now the game-winning run 90 feet away with one out in the inning.
They'll intentionally walk Veritek here to load the bases, pull everybody in, infield and outfield, and take their chances with Baega and Sanchez.
Posada standing straight up, and they will indeed put him on.
The bunts I can't predict, but that I could.
Well, the intentional walk of Jason Veritek. As the Red Sox will have the bases loaded, when we are set here with one out.
Brady really feels the pressure, doesn't he?
Very tense. There's ball four to Veritek. He'll make his way down to first. Base is loaded, one out. And here comes one of the better stories of 2002. Carlos Baerga back in the major leagues and in a heck of a spot here for the Red Sox in the bottom of the 11th inning.
Infield in, outfield in, very close. Outfield in a spot where they can take away maybe a base hit. If they catch a pop-up in that area, they can throw somebody out at home. They're trying to get Spencer in even closer out there in right field.
Baerga, 1-for-5, a career 344 hitter with the bases loaded. A strike. Wow, that looked like it was away, but at the corner, according to Paul Schreiber.
Well, all you can say there is better on the first strike than the third strike. That may have been a gift.
Infield in all the way around. The outfield is in. The 0-1. 0-2 now to Baerga. Well, the Red Sox have the bases loaded in the eighth. And Carce got Nixon to ground out to end the eighth, and the Red Sox stranded three. Also left the bases loaded back in the fourth. They're loaded in the 11th. Carce looks at third. Henderson with the lead. The 0-2. Baerga lines it to center field. Williams makes the catch. Here comes Henderson to the plate. The throw. Offline. The Red Sox win.
appeal at third.
Did Ricky leave early? The celebration starts.
They're going to make an appeal. Let's see what happens.
Safe. Game over. Red Sox win it 9-8. Ricky Henderson tagging up and scoring with the ninth run. Baerga with the game-winning ribby on the sack line out to center field. So the Red Sox have taken the first two games of this four-game series. The 3-1 win last night, the 9-8 victory tonight. It took 11 of them. Well, a terrific comeback for the Yankees, but the win for the Red Sox, 9-8. And the Red Sox lead moves to three games over the Yankees. The Red Sox atop of the AL East. They add on to that lead. Rolando Arojo, two fine innings of relief, picks up his third win, 3-1. Carce takes a loss, 1-2. The Red Sox win it 9-8 in 11 innings. Be sure and stay with us for extra innings coming up next on NESN.